All right, welcome to another episode of the Jumping the Rail podcast here on the JTR Podcast Network. This is Mark Ribbon coming to you from the Noodles Position in Champaign, Illinois. Joined as always by my buddy Menders. And Menders, I think the most ridiculous part about that video is the headlamp on my head while I'm working on the headset.
Oh, that's still one of my favorite clips.
Oh, I can tell because I see you chuckling every time.
Mm-hmm. Every time I laugh. Because I think it's hilarious.
Oh, I know you do.
I just wish everybody could have been there and heard his actual reaction. Because yeah. He's like, oh, I think that pissed him off.
It's great. No, I've got to say, for one of our anniversary shows, maybe I'll bust that out so you can hear everything. But
you better. I want it. I want the whole copy of it.
Oh, I know you do. So of course we started with the 10 bells at the top, Menders, because we lost a good one this week.
We lost the legendary, what my nightmares were made out of.
Yes.
Back in the 80s.
It's a guy we've had some fun with over various fantasy drafts and super cards and things. Usually when Bari starts doing his King Curtis impression.
Ugh.
But Kevin Sullivan passed away last week and kind of out of the blue, from what I heard. He had an accident like a month ago.
He had been in Florida.
Yeah.
I think he was at a convention or something.
He was at some kind of event, yeah.
Yeah.
And then just spiraled from there. It was crazy.
Because they even had like a GoFundMe page and everything. Because yeah. Corny had it. He was talking about it.
Corny was talking about it, yeah. It's sad business. I'm sick of doing these 10 bell salutes on the show.
It was like
5 or 6 weeks in a row at one point, didn't we?
Yeah.
It was always somebody.
So I wonder if we're going to have three now coming up, because usually it goes in threes.
Okay, so we had Sully, then Pietrov.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. His name is, I'm thinking of all of the territory Russian characters and I'm not forget which one would be disrespectful. I'm kind of bummed because I missed out on my chance to meet Kevin Sullivan at the expo this past year, Menders, because of that damn sting line.
I totally missed it. I didn't make it to him at all.
Yeah. So that's going to be one that I'm going to kick myself for. Our buddy Narge actually did meet him a few years ago, got a picture of him.
I saw the picture with
the golden spike. It was pretty cool. So, yeah. One thing that was cool, Menders, I don't know if you saw this or not. You know, Sully was a big Red Sox fan because he's from Boston. Mm-hmm. And Fenway Park did something really cool the other day. They put it up on the big scoreboard at Fenway Park.
Aww.
So, I thought that was a really classy move by them.
I like it when things like that happen, when it like cross.
Mm-hmm.
It crosses over to different sports too, that people don't just laugh at it. You know what I mean?
I do. Did you catch Paul Ellering's tribute to Sully last night?
I did.
Okay.
There it is.
Put up the big black X just like Florida Sullivan. Yeah, he scared the pants off a lot of people back then.
And, I was terrified of him. I was terrified of Kevin. Then I start figuring things out.
But
I thought he was brilliant. So
yeah, but back everything I've read in Florida back in the late 70s, early 80s, everybody was terrified of him. They thought he was a legit like devil worshipping psycho.
Hey Reb, wore this for a reason today.
Yeah, that's true. But yeah, we wanted to take a minute at the top of the show to talk about Kevin Sullivan. I don't remember him for his matches as much. What?
There were some things he did that I questioned a lot. But
yeah, some of the stuff he did with Precious back in the late 80s was a little bit of a head scratcher. But anyway, yeah, it's like I don't remember him as much for his matches as I do for his character work and his booking and all that kind of stuff.
Right.
So. Big varsity club guy back in the day. But anyway, let's move on, Menders. You know what time it is, because before we got our guest waiting.
We
got in on time today. A lot of guys came in a little bit late. But we're going to be joined by Jeremy Hamilton, ring announcer from the Midwest. He's several independent promotions. So we're looking forward to that. We'll have him on here in a couple minutes. But before we do, Manners, we got to test your brain.
Okay.
This one might be easy.
It might be easy. I've heard this before.
It's off-putting, but it might be easy.
It's off-putting, but it might... Oh, great. Okay.
All right. So here we go. All right, it is time for Name That Wrestler. Menders, you know how this works. I throw up a picture from a wrestler past or present from their younger days. You have to guess who it is. And
is it a black and white picture or color picture?
It is a color picture, but the contrast is a little wonky on it. It is a current wrestler. Okay,
so it's a current person. That's where I was going.
Okay, so here we go. And again, I warn you, off-putting. Scorpio.
Is that LA Knight?
Yep, I thought you'd get on the first time.
Yeah, I didn't even need help with that one.
I wonder if he has to live that down at all.
Probably.
Yeah.
I got it without any help from anybody. I'm so proud.
You go up to the lady and say, let me talk to you. And they're like, no.
No, I'm good. All right, let's get on to our good Judys and good hoots.
All right, we got to do our hoots and Judys real quick. AJ and Bari were onto it. They figured that. Well, so I didn't think it'd be hard.
He doesn't look that different.
No, that's except for the really beard.
Doesn't. Yeah, well, body that paint. Can almost kind of. I didn't. I tried not to look at the body paint. Yeah, thanks.
It's hard not to. All right. Hoot of the week, Menders. I'm not going to say you cheated because I okayed it, but
you did okay. I asked if I could before.
You asked, so I allowed it. You're going co-hoots this week.
Co-hoots. And I'm going co-hoots with Bron Breakker and Sami Zayn for last night's match because holy crap, that was really good.
Hey, Menders, did you see the message I sent as soon as I found out that match was 2 out of 3 falls?
Yeah, you said Braun has to go 2. It could still go 3, but he has to win 2 in a row.
Exactly. Braun had to take 2 straight, and that's what he did.
He sure did.
I hate it when they go back and forth, like when it's one fall, then a deciding third fall. It's just too formulaic. So I like it when they have somebody win 2 straight. I would have loved it if he would have just won the first 2 falls.
You knew that wasn't happening. Come on.
I know, but still.
I mean... That spear, though, that he caught Sammy with, oh!
Well, the one off the ropes?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was tight.
There was a few things in that match, though. I was like, oh, okay, all right, this is what we're doing. All right, yeah. Gotcha.
Sammy has been very good for Braun.
He has been, and now we're going to get Sammy and Jay
against the Judgment Day.
Yeah.
Makes me wonder who they're going to have challenge Braun next. Because we've thrown out some ideas, Ilya Dragunov being one of them. Or
I don't think it's going to be Ilya yet.
It can't be anywhere from the Judgment Day yet because, number one, they're heels. Number two, they're busy with Priest and Rhea. Right.
So it can't be Priest.
No.
I
don't think they'd do it with Priest this fast after losing the world title.
True. I don't know.
If Braun was a... babyface, I would love it to be my good hoot of the week, Menders. How's that for a segue?
There you go.
Big Bronson Reed.
That was actually who I was going to suggest, but he's a heel. How are you going to do that?
It was a big hoss fight, man.
I know it's a big hoss fight. I know.
But the fucking thing he pulled on R-Truth last night.
I was heartbroken, dude. Why'd you have pick on R-Truth?
Because if he did it to The Miz, he would have got over.
I know.
I'll tell you what I was waiting for. When I was waiting for him to lay out Pierce.
I think that's coming.
It's got to happen.
It's either coming or he's going to have him over a barrel somehow.
Somehow. I think that's going to be our Vader Gorilla Monsoon moment.
There you go.
96.
That works.
Because when Pierce was getting in Bronson's face in the ring, I was waiting for him to just give him a Death Valley driver, then drop a splash or two on him.
Yep.
And then really get it over. But then again, he might have got cheered.
Yeah, true.
Pierce isn't the most popular authority figure on the show.
He's not, but yeah. As long as he didn't land on Jason Jordan, I'm okay.
Right. Hey, Jamie Noble was rolling.
He was on a roll.
Bully Ray put him over on Busted Open this morning.
Oh, I'm sure he did. That doesn't surprise me at all.
No. But yeah, I'm very curious what they're going to keep doing with him going forward. I mean, he can't keep killing all the baby faces.
No. Because right now, we got Jay as a baby face, Sammy as a baby face.
Priest, Punk.
Seth, when he comes back.
You could do Sheamus.
Sheamus is too busy with Pete right now.
Plus, Sheamus just came back, so.
Yeah.
AJ chiming in. His good hoot of the week is Santos Escobar.
Santos.
He told LA Knight it's a fact of life that he'll be the next U.S. champion that gave Andrade his first pinfall loss since returning on SmackDown. Yeah, there you go. I like that Escobar.
I do, too. We've been following him for a while.
Well, yeah, you guys are Lucha Underground guys, so.
Yeah,
we were. Ever since he was King.
King Cuerno.
I don't say Cuervo.
He's not a tequila peddling luchador. He's not tequila. All right, but let's move on to our good Judy, because I'm
sorry. We have a special Judy this week, Menders. We are unanimous on the Judy for a very special reason.
We were.
We had to shout out the original good Judy this week, Menders. The legendary Judy Martin. She had a little medical procedure going on this week. And I forget what it was for sure. Lonnie Kai posted it on her Facebook.
It was with her heart.
Yeah. But it sounds like the surgery went well. She's going to make a recovery. So
now let's show why this is the universal good Judy and why we have this.
You just want to see the clip again.
I do. It's great.
All right. Well, I take you back to season 3, episode 8, the third fantasy draft, 1980s edition. And our friend had a little meltdown, Menders.
Just a tiny bit.
I have not picked a single woman for my roster, given that Sherry got took. Why don't I take two and make up for the deal? I will take the glamour girls.
God, you son of a bitch!
The first time I've ever heard that much rage over the glamour girls.
That was literally my next pick.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right.
Hang on, let me get the picture up here. I didn't see the Glamour Girls as a team outside of their stuff with the Jumping Bomb Angels.
Yeah, women's tag team champions during their era.
And AJ, you get Jimmy Hart.
You took Judy Martin from me. You took Judy Martin. No one ever. You took Jimmy Hart from me.
No, you can still get Jimmy, Barry. I mean, he goes with whoever.
It doesn't matter. He took Judy Martin from me. Look at her.
You took your Judy.
My Judy. My good Judy.
You have a bad
Judy? I'm devastated.
There's a bad Judy? Okay. One of my favorites.
That really never gets old.
It really doesn't. I love Judy Gate.
Oh, my favorites. It really is. So yeah, speedy recovery to Judy Martin, and still on top of my list. I want to get her on the pod sometime. Maybe maybe a package deal.
Let her recover first.
Oh yeah, of course. I'm not an animal.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
Regret nothing. #Judygate.
Always stirring it up.
There was a lot of aggravating on that. If you ever get a chance and want to see us all yell at each other a few times,
mm-hmm.
Go to that one. That's
one I recommend watching the video of more than listening to the podcast.
You were salty.
You pissed me off. First pick of the friggin' draft, Menders.
I know I did.
All right. Well, that's something to review later on. We still have to do our Stooge of the Week, Menders.
Oh, yeah, our Stooge of the Week.
this is a funny one. Our Stooge of the Week comes from Monday Night Raw. I'm sorry, Barry. She asked me to play it.
We can't because it's great.
But anyway, our stooge of the week is the Monday Night Raw graphics department.
Tornado.
No. Torrendo. The Alpha Academy versus American Made Texas Torrendo tag team match. And if that's not bad enough, Menders, when they came to the ring, they never fixed it.
I know.
They fixed Academy, but they let Torrendo. And then finally, somebody must have said something, because when they came back from commercial break, then they fixed it at the smallest angle they did. Like how the bigger the size of the Chiron, the more errors there were.
Right? It's great.
Texas Torrendo. Just like the Texas Torrendo, Kerry Von Erich. That's right. But I told you that will not happen again, because you know there's going to be double checking and triple checking going forward on those graphics.
Yeah. Move your hand; you're blocking your mic.
Sorry. The Von Erich boys had many classic Torrendo matches against the Freemans. Oh, hey, look who's here, Menders.
Hey, Free Rider, Wild Rider. Well, there we go.
Wild Screen Rider.
I got it.
You'll get it. You'll figure it out.
I debated. Have you seen that yet?
I still haven't watched the Iron Claw yet.
Oh my gosh!
I'm weird. I got a thing about biopics.
This one will probably frustrate you, honestly.
Yeah,
probably frustrate you.
It's awesome that they got a movie and they got spotlighted like that. But
the guy that plays Ric Flair, was it Ric Flair?
I heard the guy who played Flair was awful. I heard the guy that played Fritz was actually really good.
Yeah, he was fine. The one played Flair was terrible.
I should have got Will Ferrell to reprise Ashley Schaefer from Eastbound and Down.
There you go. All right. Is our guest still in?
It's not accurate at all.
No, it's not.
But that's the thing. A lot of people can get away from. They can not think about that. It'd be all I would think about.
Yeah. Hey, let's. There you go. I'm gonna let you introduce this one because I want to see how you would introduce because I'm thinking of Voice of the Indies, but I feel like I would upset.
That might be a little gimmick infringement.
Might James, be a little bit.
James is friends with the guy that played Flair. Okay. Hey.
Oh wow.
All right. Well, Menders, let's bring our guest in. One of the top ring announcers in the Midwest. I first was aware of him through Hybrid Championship Wrestling. I don't know about you, but
mine might have been New Wave, actually.
Okay. But he's also the new ring announcer for All Vermillion Wrestling in my neck of the woods up in Oakwood. So say hello to Jeremy Hamilton. How are you, sir? Hi.
I'm great. Thanks for having me. How are you guys?
Oh, we're good.
Can you hear us now?
Yeah, I can hear you just fine now. I'm the king of technical difficulties. I'll warn you that.
I challenge you.
Challenge accepted.
All I'll say is this.
Oh, yeah.
Those are flying across the room.
He's bit the dust.
On air.
Yeah, right in front of the grappler.
Well, I'll do you one better. I'm in my son's room on his computer using his equipment because of my technical difficulties. So I don't even have my own gear right now.
There you go. Do what you got to do, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah,
all right, Rep. Are we starting off with our normal question?
Hit it.
All right. Normal question we ask everybody. How did you get into the business and who did you look up to when you were a kid?
Well, how I got into the business was pretty easy. It was actually only about 2.5 years ago. I worked with J.C. Carnage here in Vincennes for quite a while, and he and Brian Parker were starting up Envision Wrestling. So I threw my hat in the ring for that, and they let me have a couple half shows to start off, and it kicked off from there. And as far as people that I looked up to in the business, it's hard for me to not say Andre the Giant, just because – I mean, as a kid, you always looked at him as he was the heel, but you could always see that he wasn't that person. You know, he always played that great heel, but you could always see that there was that that kindness and compassion and just a real gentle giant there that, you know, you could really look up to and, you know, you just, you connected with. So
yeah. I love Andre. When I first started watching, it was right around WrestleMania 1, so he was right on that tail end of his babyface run. Mm-hmm. So, and this is when I'm, I don't know, 5 years old or so.
So you're four or five.
Yeah. So when he turned on Hogan, that blew my mind because I was like, holy crap. I never pictured Andre being a bad guy.
Yeah. And no matter what he did, he was the center of that universe.
Yes.
You know, all the action revolved around his pivot. So, you know, he really held his own no matter what he was doing.
Yeah. It's kind of how everybody looked at The Undertaker in the locker room when he was there. That was Andre first. He was the boss for a reason. So,
yeah, absolutely. Some of those guys just command respect.
Yeah.
So we know you're in quite a few promotions, that you work for a lot of promotions around here. Did you get your running list of all the promotions you have been in? Because that you say that, I think Envision was actually the first place that I saw Jeremy.
Yeah.
Now that he said that.
Their first show was my first show. And then about a Matt year House after that. Yeah. Oh my. That was such a great match. It was such a great show.
So fun.
Oh, it was really. Those first few shows were just a blast. I mean, the crowds were great. They were huge because it was just a new promotion and everybody was ready for it. Oh, we had an amazing time. And then about a year later, Stephen Mitchell brought me on for Elite Pro Wrestling. Started with their anniversary show there, and I've been doing that ever since. I'm also, you know, as you said, I'm for NVW now. I'm their full-time announcer as well as AVW. So thanks to Cecil and those guys for that. I'm having a blast there. But I've also I've worked for XCW out of Madisonville, Indiana, and Refocused out of Evansville. And then I did a show for D6 out of Macomb as well. So I'm getting around in just 2.5 years. I'm getting a good amount of experience here, I think.
Yeah.
Definitely sounds like it. And it's not Cecil, it's Seashell.
Seashell, as we say. Oh, I got the pleasure of hanging out with him on Saturday night. We had a blast.
Yeah.
It was Clayton Clark's birthday, so.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, yeah, it was us and Dalton Davis and Dickie Wabash and Brian Parker. And I saw Aaron Atlas there, and
yeah,
we had a good time.
We love Aaron.
We were there when he got hurt at the theater show.
Oh, yeah.
We were there when Dalton got hurt. Yeah.
That was awful. I felt so bad for him. He was really setting up for a big run of things coming up too. So
yeah,
you know,
well, it wouldn't have been so bad, but he had taken like a really bad ladder shot like the night before, and
oh, he bounced off that ladder so hard.
He was fine, and then it was literally the most simple jump out of the ring, and we were all like, he's not getting up. Why is he not getting up?
Just Clayton started stalling for time. I was like, what happened? Something went wrong.
What happened? So
yeah. And Dalton's a tough SOB. So if he's not getting up, you know something's wrong for sure.
Yeah.
Because we're like, why are they stalling? They shouldn't be stalling. Why are they stalling? Yeah.
Then I think it was CMC's mom running with a bag of ice over there, and
oh yeah,
people converging and like, yeah, that's not good. So
yeah.
So I'm glad he's doing good. Hopefully the recovery time isn't too bad for him. So.
Yeah, he was up walking around in his moon boot. He seems to be in good spirits. So
good deal.
It was really great to have some time with him.
Yeah.
Trust me, a broken foot sucks. That was what I dealt with last year.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I thought I remember seeing you walking around on a moon boot too.
I was in a wheelchair.
Oh, that's right. Yes, I do recall that now. Yes.
Because I used to try to run Clayton Clark over.
Mm-hmm. And take his hat.
And take his hat. And that was before, but that was before I realized he was a corny guy. And now I'm emotionally torn at the whole situation of, no, you're supposed to hate him, but he's a corny guy. No, you're supposed to hate. It just happens.
Yeah.
So now you take Joey O'Reilly's hat.
Yeah. Now I steal Joey O'Reilly's hat.
Oh, he deserves it.
Yep, sure does.
All right. Low life.
He's not low life anymore. He's the roughneck.
Oh, yeah, really? I got you. I remember that.
Yeah. Lowlife had their swan song in the War Games a few months ago. So what was it that drew you to ring announcing? Like, did you ever think about being like a referee or a manager or anything like that?
No, I really didn't. As far as wrestling and, you know, boxing, MMA or whatever that, I was always drawn to the ring announcers. I grew up a big Michael Buffer fan. I was always going around the house going, you know, let's get ready to rumble and whatnot. And, you know, I'd annoy my parents with that. And then, you know, I think I started a degree in radio and I never really finished that, but I always still wanted to do something with my voice. And when this came along, I was like, I'm going to go for it, you know, and now I'm doing this as well as emceeing for music festivals and stuff. And it's really taken off. You know, I've always just been that. I don't want to be up front. I don't want to be the superstar, but I want to play my part and I want to have some fun with it. And
yeah.
You like picking on people in the crowd. We understand.
You know, that's one of my specialties. I'm a bit of a pest.
You got to do the crowd work.
Absolutely. Not me. It's not me. I swear.
I think that's a big part of the job. I mean,
yeah.
You know, there's a lot of stalling in a wrestling event. So you've got to keep the crowd engaged and entertained. So, you know, especially with the kids there, you got to keep them enthralled.
So out of, because since you've been around to a lot of the independents, is there anybody that you've seen that we really need to keep an eye on that you've been impressed with? I mean, I know you have your group of friends. Like, I know you're like Clayton, Dalton, all those guys.
Oh, yeah. And,
but I mean, is there anybody that hasn't really hit where they're a name in the Midwest that you think people should probably keep their eye on?
Well, I tell you what, the last ABW show, there were a couple good names that really surprised me. I'd never gotten to see Christian Rose. I know he's more of a bigger name in the Midwest, but I mean, I had never been to one of his matches, and I was so impressed. I mean, he's such a great performer. And I tell you what, that triple threat match, Zay Gates.
Yeah.
He really stood out to me. I mean, that guy can move.
Yeah.
You know, and you know, really at the ABW show, there were quite a few people there that I hadn't been able to see before because I don't really make it out to the shows because I'm generally working, you know, my own shows.
Right.
So I think in that respect, you know, a lot of the talent at ABW that you're seeing right now, you know, people need to step up to Jimmy Carrot to see what he's doing. You know, I realize he's a bigger name in this area, but I'm saying he needs to get out there as far as his name needs to blow up for sure, because hell of a performer. Absolutely. Yeah. Whether you like him or not, you can't deny him. He puts on a show.
Mm-hmm.
May or may not be one of the number one fans. May or may not be.
Yeah, I'm telling you.
I mean,
you.
He's went through that table there. Well, hello, Noodles. He's been through that table there. There's his flag. I have a Basil Crossing sign. You know, it's fine.
When are you getting your life-size standee of Jimmy Carrot for your house?
I don't need a life-size standee. I don't need a life-size standee.
I say Oliver Kane's another one.
He's so good. Oh, I love Oliver.
Yeah, he's great with the crowd. He's got that personality that really pulls off his act. And, you know, he's fun to watch. He's great in the locker room. He's great to be around.
Shank's another one of my favorites. He's so fun.
The one show that I got to work with Shank was definitely one of the most fun shows that I've had because he and Kendall Fire had a handcuff match. And it was the main event. So at the end of the night, Shank is handcuffed there and everybody's starting to leave and everything, walking by him and waving. So I took my chance to hop up there and have a fun interview with him. And we kind of got the crowd involved and he was yelling at me and really showing off that Shank personality. I had a great time with it. I can't wait to work with him again.
We used to see him at UWC when Homer was running, Homer, Illinois. And we called him King. He was King there. So Shank is King.
Does Cobra know about this?
Uh-oh.
Yes, Cobra knows. Cobra knows he was there. Now, Cobra is Strike King. Shank is the King.
Then you got Mojo McQueen. If he ever comes back around again, he was the Voodoo King.
Right. AJ put up a comment there, Reb.
My notes are blocking the comments notifications, so that's why I was missing. All right, AJ says, far be it for me to disparage the name of 5'7" Gift from Heaven. Great guy, total professional, should get more respect and around here than he does.
Absolutely. Absolutely. He's one of those guys that leads a locker room, and he puts on a heck of a show.
He does. He's such a nice guy. Mm-hmm. Even if he's being a jerk, he's still a nice guy. It's been known to happen a few times.
You know, everybody's got that side.
So what do you have coming up? I know this weekend you've got, I'm assuming you're
going to be busy this weekend.
You're busy this weekend.
I'll be at Hybrid on Saturday, and then I'll be at AVW on Sunday. And both of
so will we.
Huge events.
So will we.
Huge events.
We'll be at both.
I can't wait. Yeah, we missed Hybrid last month, so I'm ready to get back around and see some more of those stories play out and see what's going on with that. You know, it's one of those things that I'm starting to learn in the business. This year was the first time I've ever actually had any cancellations. So to see, you don't ever expect your building to be the problem, you know, and that's the same thing that happened with EPW just recently. The building was double booked. So, you know, you can't really expect that stuff. And it's sad that it happens, but they're going to pick it up strong and come back on this next event. I think it's going to be awesome. I mean,
I'm interested to see how Hybrid's going to pivot now, because with, especially with Dalton being hurt. Mm-hmm. So I'm hoping
the world title's still vacant there, right?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Yep.
Because Patrick's had to vacate.
Yep. He's in Japan.
Yeah, he's doing a lot in Japan right now. That's pretty amazing. I'm really impressed with him. You know, I only got to work with him a couple times at Hybrid because he'd kind of been in and out, but those two times were just awesome. He's such a classy guy. Really enjoyed working with Dale Patrick's, and I'm happy to see his success over there for sure.
Yeah.
I have one of his shirts, Reb.
Yeah. Oh, I know. That's a guy I'd love to see step up to Carrot at some point. I think those two have a hell of a match.
You've been saying that for a minute.
But problem also, is, I know Menders wouldn't be getting nervous because of all the deathmatch stuff.
I'd be extremely. So I hate with a passion death matches. Hate them. And what is Carrot doing? I hate them. And Carrot enjoys doing them. And I'm like, I hate you. I think you're awesome, but I hate you because I can't. Well, it bothers me.
I'll say that at one point I suggested to Jimmy that he and the guy he was feuding with in 01 should blow off their feud, because the feud was almost a year with a no rope barbed wire match. It didn't happen, but Menders almost killed me when she heard me suggest that.
Too much gore for you, huh?
Too much. It's not even so much that. I think what my problem is that a lot of these wrestlers, especially with us doing this now, we've actually become friends with a lot of them. So then to see them, like, I understand that's their passion. I get all that. I still don't want to see them hurt. Yeah. And even if I'm not friends with them, I don't want to see them get hurt. I don't want it to be like with Dalton, like when Dalton broke his foot or whatever.
That was just a free thing. That's not even a death match.
You know, that's.
Or when Chris O'Brien broke his arm at Terre Haute.
Now, Joey broke his arm.
I know Joey broke his arm, but that's what I'm saying. And it was all in fluke things that it happened. But then you have Carrot, who's the moron that goes off of a 30-foot freaking ladder at Decatur and lands on concrete and can't walk for 2 weeks. Ooh, let's do it again. How about no? Let's not do it again.
Well, first you don't succeed.
I'm so glad I wasn't taking a drink just now.
I would have got it, wouldn't I? I would have got
you would have got it.
Damn it.
We need a good spit take.
Both of us have been trying with the other one for a long, like 2 years.
I just really don't want to get it on my computer.
Yeah, we don't want to get it on our computer.
Got to get splash guards since it's a spit take contest.
Oh, jeez. So, I know you don't want to pick favorites, but I'm putting you on the spot.
Okay.
Which one of the promotions do you enjoy being at the most because of the fans, because of the talent, because of the storylines?
I tell you, it's really hard to differentiate, because as much as you would think indie promotions would be so similar, they're really not. You know, I mean, for instance, I went to that ABW show a few weeks back. And it is so much bigger of a production than what I'm used to. So, I mean, I fell in love with the lights, the sound, the outdoor atmosphere, the whole 210 saloon. You know, it was great. It had the limo pull in to drop people off and stuff like that. So, you know, I would honestly say, as far as feeling like home, Hybrid probably does, and EPW especially, because those two are the ones that I've kind of had the most shows with now. And both locker rooms are very similar as far as talent. So I see a lot of the same guys there. So as far as going from, you know, 45 minutes between the two. You know, it really does feel like kind of a group home for those two promotions, because, you know, they really welcomed me in with open arms, and they all pushed me as well, you know, to be better and prod me to bring more out of myself. So I really appreciate that from, you know, Steven Mitchell and Austin Ryan, because, you know, those are guys that are, you know, still coming up in the business themselves, and they're trying to improve everybody around them.
Yeah.
You know, and I think that's the most important thing in a business like this, because I have it myself, because I'm kind of on my own, really, but I see people get lost. You know, it's easy for somebody who isn't necessarily feeling their oats to sit in the corner in a locker room and not necessarily build their confidence based on the relationships and interactions that they would have with some people. But I don't see that in the locker rooms that I'm in. I see everybody in there building each other up and patting each other on the back, you know, introducing each other to people. So it's been really rewarding in that sense that, you know, I've just had a lot of talent around me to make me better. As you know, like I said, especially in EPW and hybrid, because I've been with them, you know, the longest now, and just become great groups of friends.
We're big fans of hybrid. I made friends with them. Lindsay and I became really good friends. So then they watch out for me. I watch out for them. We tried to push them on the show as much as possible. And, yeah. You know, it's like, it has, it's, I consider these people, you know, some of my best friends, and it's awesome. Yeah, I miss Drive 365 so much.
Yeah, that's a cool setup that you guys had.
That's there. A great setup there.
Yeah, those are fun shows.
Are you guys gonna,
feeling.
Yeah. Are you guys going to go back to Strive anytime, or are you guys camped out at West Vigo for the foreseeable future?
I'm not sure exactly what's going on with that. I know that they'd had that issue with the building back in July, the beginning of July, so I'm not sure what's happening with that. I know they were trying to run a training camp out of there at some point too. So mm-hmm. I'll have to see what Austin's got going on there.
Yeah. Softball and baseball can really wreak a havoc with some of the wrestling, especially when that's what they're founded just, on. So
just ask Sid Vicious.
Yeah. Ask Sid Vicious.
Hey, Crash and Burn's at the AVW show, right? Menders. Are they taking on trauma? Is Crash and Burn taking on Trauma Unit at the AVW?
Yes. Yep. I know, I'm so torn. You don't understand, Reb.
Yeah.
I'm so torn. Those are my boys.
Well, I mean,
it is my crew.
Think about it. It's Devontae, it's Theo, or it's Aaron. Just got to think about it that way.
What? How do I look at it? What'd you say?
It's either Devontae and Theo, or it's Aaron.
What about Austin?
Yeah, what about Austin?
You like Austin. You don't like Aaron.
That's true.
Oh, okay.
I see where you're going.
Austin's good people. You always have to give Aaron a shit about everything.
No, but you don't understand. When I first met Austin, we called him Bobby Hill. I about got it again. Did you see that? I about got it again.
Oh, get off the video games, Bobby.
I don't know him. We called him Bobby Hill. So
that's great.
Because he wanted to be a bad guy. So we were just fans in the crowd at that point. He comes up to us. He's like, "Hey, I want to be a bad guy." We're like, "All right. I don't think you know what you're asking for, but okay, we got you." Yeah. Our crew, you only basically have been around Reb and I, and you know, we have a couple others that are in our crew.
Oh yeah. I've heard about the crew.
Yeah.
It's pretty rowdy.
We're a little bit rowdy, but you tell the crew what you want. We'll help you do whatever it is that you want to do. If you want to get over, okay, we'll get you over. That was how we killed Clayton a couple times, because we were calling him Bang Bang Bart from the Simpsons. So, you know, it's just kind of like, you tell us if you want to be a good guy or a bad guy. We'll come up with it. Fight with us. It's fine.
Those are the
times.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. Yep. Every time Austin walked into the Homer Opera House, he would be greeted by Bobby Hill chants. And that's my purse. I don't know you. We're so mean. Sometimes.
Did you say Bobby Hill like Min Super Nuisance Thumb?
Yeah. Yeah.
Stacy will pop if she hears this, because she loves King of the Hill. So all this King of the Hill talk will really tickle her.
But it's like, so now you have Destination Six. Who all is up? I mean, we know Sam Knight was up there. Is he still up there or is he done up
not
there?
Not that I'm aware of. Not that we're aware of. I thought he was been there since January, but I did see that that big match that Shank and Chris Cutler and Kendall Fire have coming up there. That's going to be huge.
That's going to be
absolutely, yeah. And I think Oliver Kane, he took a belt up there as well. Yeah, so.
As he deserves it. He deserves it.
For sure. They've got such a great atmosphere and such a great show over there at D6. You know, I hear they're selling out like crazy. So anybody should check that out. Yeah. That church that they have their shows in is amazing.
I thought it was at a church.
Mm-hmm. It's a huge church. Yeah, built in like the 1800s, she was telling me, and it's got all the stained glass still in it. The big pipe organ's back behind the ring. Yeah, it's something to take in for sure.
Is it still a working church, or is it just you guys use the building?
Just the Church of Wrestling now.
Love it. That's all you need. So what do we got coming up at Envision? Isn't there another Envision show coming up too? I'm testing your memory here.
Envision will actually be off until next year.
Okay.
They're sorting out, trying to get buildings and funding and things like that to get come back in the next year a little bit stronger. Because here in Vincennes, it's kind of hard to find a place, a good place to put on a wrestling show. So it tends to fall through a lot. So it's really hard to plan your yearly schedule based on that. We did have a great run at the National Guard Armory, but I'm not sure what's going on with that. So probably early next year for Envision.
No, I would say the Armory is where I went when I went down there to go see. Mm-hmm. I went down to see, it was Matt Cross and Aaron Atlas and I don't remember who the other one was. It was a triple threat.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember that as well. That's been so long ago now.
Well, it was their first show because the whole reason I went down there was because of Matt Cross. I'm a huge Matt Cross fan.
Same here.
Lucha Underground was one of my favorite shows, or I love Lucha. So, Son of Havoc, let's do this.
Did you get the Masket Hybrid, or was that just AJ did that?
No, I got the Masket Hybrid. I got the Son of Havoc Masket Hybrid.
Oh, sweet.
I got his T-shirt down at him when I went to Envision. So. Hmm. But yeah, because I went down to that one. That was a solo trek that I took on my own. Go figure. Mm-hmm. I'm a little bit of a renegade sometimes, but it happens.
All right, I do that. If you're ready to go, you're ready to go. It doesn't matter who wants to go with you, right?
Right. Have you been at Signal 10? Have you not been over there at that one yet?
No, I haven't yet. Okay. I've heard good things, though. I've heard they're pretty awesome.
Very much so. Jake Ullman is amazing. We've had him, friend of the show.
Uh-huh.
We've had Jake Ullman on.
Mr. International.
Yeah, I've heard really good things about Signal 10. I've heard they've got great production. They put their talent over really well. So, yeah, I definitely want to get up and check that out sometime.
Go ahead, Red.
Oh.
Your turn.
All right. Well,
Johnny Carter? What is he talking about?
Shoni Carter?
Uh-huh.
James, you have to kind of give a little context on this one. I'm not real sure what you're going for there.
We have a couple guys that have just like randomly found us on YouTube.
Oh yeah, so they're just in the middle of the conversation thing.
Well, no, now they're like they like showed up at one show and then now they've been watching ever since because they enjoy listening to us. So, wrong box.
Oops. I hate when that happens. It's all good.
But. We have these random people that just happen to pop up and send us chats and our stuff. We're like, okay, we have no clue. So this is one of the guys that we've actually become pretty good friends with just because he showed up at a Just Incredible interview, which was kind of fun. Yeah.
And he loves your work.
Yeah. And we love the love. We appreciate the patronage, I guess is the best word there.
Oh, that's the thing too. Like the fans in this wrestling world, whether it be on the podcast or in the arena or, you know, on Twitter or whatever it is, it's just awesome. I mean, they're very adamant fans and they're very knowledgeable fans. And
thank you.
Great.
We try.
Shout out Papa Pullman in the chat, Menders.
Papa Pullman's
in the chat. We're going to talk about him tomorrow.
Tomorrow night, we're talking about Papa Pullman. So
That was an experience.
There was a Zero Friday. One show this past Friday.
No, no, it was an Anakin Murphy show. Oh, it was not a right. Zero One show. It was just at their
Murphy show. Dojo.
Yeah, I saw that. That was the tax return show.
Yeah, tax return show. It was definitely an experience.
Oh yeah.
So yeah, tune in tomorrow for us to talk about that.
I will.
Although we did get Gary J and B.A. Malkin though in the main event.
Yeah, we did get Gary J and B.A. Malkin. So that was I'll put it this way. I came home with a fish.
I got a signed fish.
I got a signed fish.
Hopefully it doesn't start to smell later.
It shouldn't, because it's actually it's plastic.
See, I think if I were to have fish, I would have to have real fish. I would just sign those.
I was kind of disappointed they didn't use real fish in that fishing challenge they did Friday. But
in the kiddie pool?
I mean, I guess we don't want to, you know, torture and abuse fish, but...
Well, that's true.
You know,
well,
if I happen to see some in the supermarket, I might autograph a few and set them out on the table.
There you go. There you go. Just think of that matches in Seattle that you go to that fish market.
Yeah, right, there you go. Have some thrown at me.
Does this mean we can actually go through what part of the hybrid card is for this weekend, since we're going?
I don't have any of the graphics, but if you got them on your phone there, we can just run them down.
Give me a minute.
Yeah, I've got. I talked to Austin today. He sent me a good portion of the hybrid card.
Yeah.
Ooh, really?
Yeah.
I'm very interested.
Menders, are we doing picks like we do on Wednesdays?
Yeah, let's do picks.
Okay. Well, let's start off with match one.
All right.
We've got Christian Rose versus Ace Perry.
Oh,
you guys that have been at it for years.
Y'all
Ace wants to be Christian, or used to want to be Christian, and now he's facing his hero. What's it going to be?
Man,
I'm in pain trying to figure this one out.
Well, I'll give you a second to think, Menders.
All right.
I think I'm going to go with Ace, just because it's kind of home territory for Ace. You know,
going with the Christian's, Black Diamond.
I'm going with the Black Diamond. He's a friend of the show. He's been on the show before.
He's awesome.
Yeah.
We love Ace. Papa Pullman. Of course he chimes in.
Christian Rose. Okay. I'm going to be pulling for Christian Rose hard in October.
What?
He's got CMC.
Oh, really? That's right. Oh, that's at Pro Wrestling Glory.
Yes.
No. We don't know that for a fact yet.
That's not official, but...
That's not official.
Doofus put a promo out there saying he wanted Christian Rose.
Did you say Doofus?
Maybe. we have issues, me and CMC.
Got beef.
Oh, they yeah.
They got beef. For some reason, they have beef. It started... Well, it's kind of like me and Joey have beef, and me and BA have beef. I mean, it just... And Trust. Oh, dear Lord.
Oh, Trust. You know, if you're familiar with Benjamin Trust...
No, not really.
Oh, man, you're missing out.
Wait. Isn't he? Yeah, we need to introduce you to Benjamin Trust.
Great.
We need to get Cecil to put him on an AVW show.
Oh, God.
I'll get Benjamin Trust on an AVW show.
AJ says, I like that name, Coyote, but Ace is on the way.
Do what?
Big props to Cecil, by the way. That was pretty awesome of him and Casey setting me up with that job at AVW. I couldn't be more happy with that. Yeah. You know, he really reached out for me there.
How did that come out? Just out of the woo, just called you and said, hey, we need you for a show?
Pretty well the same as all the others. Sense and Vision, it's just, you know, guys that I've worked with, seen my work, and say, hey, I'm ready for you to come work with us. So they want me to bring the tux and the loud voice and put a show on. I'm down.
How many tuxedos do you have?
I have one right now. I'm working on getting a white tux.
Yeah. Got to have a white tux.
Yeah. I'm more branching out into like the different bow ties and vests than I am the actual tuxes.
I see just some sort of lame pattern, like a gold or silver tux for those extra fancy shows.
Oh, absolutely. The gold is definitely coming one day. Yeah. There's going to be like one Elvis show that I just have to have a gold tux.
Oh, yeah.
For sure.
I don't really think you need the tux at New Version, though. Just button up shirt, vest, you'd be good.
It doesn't feel right, though. That's the thing.
Fine.
Cecil and Casey had wanted me to come to the AVW show, kind of dressed down a little bit since it was in the saloon and whatnot. So I wore my jeans and my button up shirt, but it just didn't feel right. For me, that's the uniform of the job.
Yeah.
You know, I put the tux on, I get in the mode, and that's what I do.
Have you considered a tuxedo t-shirt?
I have. Maybe, you know, for like dressing down after the show kind of thing.
Okay.
Maybe you'll see me at Tolly's in the tuxedo t-shirt after the show.
There you go.
Tie-dye tux with tails.
Oh, now we're talking.
But then you need a top hat, too.
Yeah, tie-dye top hat, too. Yep.
If not the top hat, you just look foolish.
Well, of course. I mean, top hat makes the suit.
That's right.
All right. I'm going to go with Ace.
You're going with Ace?
I'm going with Ace.
You're going to owe Christian a beer.
I'm going to owe Christian a beer is how that's going
to work. I'm going to be sure to tell him you said that.
You go right ahead, because Christian owes me a few beers. I've gotten him a few beers. He owes me a few beers. So
did you bring a 6-pack to one show?
No, I brought a 12-pack to one show.
Way to go, Manders.
She's the cool aunt.
I'm the cool aunt. I'm the cool aunt to all the wrestlers. Come on now.
All right, what's the next match?
Next match, we got Trick Davis versus Sage Phillips.
I am very excited. I am a fan of Trick Davis going all the way back to IWA Mid-South in the mid-2000s.
This could be a technical match.
Yes.
Very
He's a hero guy, so he knows all the submissions and all that stuff. So I haven't seen him in the ring in probably 15 years, I want to say. I'm very interested to see how he's going to be. What?
Did I mention Trick Davis? Sage and I got history, not a fan. So,
I'm going to pick Trick on this one, just for sentimental reasons.
Both of you on Trick, huh?
This right. Red, here's we're the... not arguing over this. What's wrong with us? One.
It's still fun when we agree on everything.
I know. We're going to have to fix that.
All right.
Well, maybe I can split you up on this one. We got the big tag team match, the Hype versus the Gorgeous Investment. It's going to be Avery Hertz and Morgan Taylor teaming up.
Oh Lord.
Talk about a lot of bling in that match.
There's a lot of bling in that match.
Well, you have sunglasses on.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay. Red, you first. No, you go first. I was first.
Oh, I got to go first.
Yep.
I believe the Hype, the last time I saw them was when they wrestled Crash and Burn at the last Hybrid show we went to, Minders.
Probably.
Yeah, that's right. And I was very impressed by them. That was my first time seeing them.
They put on an amazing match.
Yeah.
They're both really great, fast-paced wrestlers.
Yeah. Minders, should I put this up?
Yes, please. AJ says, I'm going to say the guy that isn't Johnny Gargano's midget wrestler impersonator.
How many deep is he in, Minders?
Oh, he's at least two.
Was he off today?
He was off today, so he's at least two. He might be three in. Who knows? You said you're going with the Hype.
I'm going with the Hype.
I'm gonna go with Avery Hertz and Gorgeous.
You think they're gonna take the titles?
I like that Avery Hertz. He needs some more gold. He needs some more gold.
He's fun to watch. He's got a great personality too.
He does.
Yeah, him and Gorgeous Morgan. I think that's going to be a great team up for sure. Well, I did not expect to see that one on the card, but I think it's going to be fun.
I love Gorgeous. He's so fun. He's such a good guy.
For sure. So we got the Hype, and you're going with Avery and Gorgeous, huh?
Yep.
All right.
We're split. We're finally split on one.
Well, here's a good one for you. You're going to love this. We got the War Pigs versus the O'Doyles.
The O'Doyles. I'm not familiar with the O'Doyles.
I know the O'Doyles.
I know the O'Neills.
Cecil O'Doyle.
Oh, jeez.
And Brandon O'Doyle.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, I'm going with War Pigs.
I would assume that, yes.
Cecil and I have this love-hate relationship. He loves my money and I hate him. So, we have this lovely...
Oh, do you have the picture of when you won the free tickets?
I sure do. Did you know I get into AVW this weekend for free?
Nice. How'd you pull that one off?
I won the tickets.
Oh, that's right. You did win. You won both of them.
You know she's a ringer for raffles.
I kind of am. It's kind of scary.
AJ has updated us, Minders.
I know. We were
so... He's a Monaco who has a moonshine and four vodkas in.
Yep.
We lowballed.
We lowballed.
We highballed.
Hold on. Okay, go ahead and it's in this.
I'm going to say War Pigs also.
Hey, I have a I have a table signed by Crash and Burn somewhere.
You have more shit in that room.
Actually, I think that one's out in the bitch barn.
There you go. Yeah, she has a little she shed in the backyard that she hides from society in.
See?
Oh, that's great.
He's not happy.
He hated my sweatshirt. Oh, he hated my sweatshirt. He has, like I said, we have a love-hate relationship. So.
Oh, he's such a character.
He's something.
I think he's all right. So.
Just all right? Yeah.
I don't know him that well.
We'll call that a compliment for Cecil. Cecil's there you go. Just all right.
He's all right.
All right. What's next?
We're going to have Jackson O'Doyle versus Tyler Scott.
Kiddo's on the show this time.
Kiddo, we've known Tyler for a while, so we call him Kiddo.
Oh, he's such a sweet guy.
Yeah, he's a good kid.
He is. I question his wrestling sometimes, but that is what it is. I mean, everybody kind of questions everybody's wrestling at some point. You know what? I'm gonna go Kiddo. I gotta go with Kiddo.
I'm gonna go O'Doyle.
All right.
I feel like I'm going to have to go with Mindy on this one. Tyler's got a lot of momentum right now, I feel like, especially at Hybrid.
He's got the crowd behind him. There's a lot of people at Hybrid that like Tyler.
Well, so apparently he never gives up.
Yeah, what? Never. So. Never.
Oh, wait, I have a shirt that says that. My bad. I do.
Are you still mad because he stole your fudge?
A little bit. I made fudge to give to Ace Perry, right? For yeah. Christmas. So I gave it to Tyler because we were a Hybrid show and I said, hey, take this back and give it to Ace. He gave it to Stetson.
Oh geez.
Well, apparently he calls Stetson Ace. So when I said Ace, he thought I meant Stetson. I was like, what? No.
So now in the future you say full names. It was yes. Ace Perry.
Ace Perry, not Ace Stetson.
Right.
Yeah, not that Ace. Ace Perry, please. Thank you. Yeah, so this is Benjamin Trust.
Oh. What's up with him? Who knows where that belt has been?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. A championship belt is definitely not something I would put my mouth on.
No. All right, what's our next match? What's our main event? How many more we got till the main event?
Well, that was pretty well what I've got for that card that's really been announced.
You're missing one because they announced Clayton.
Okay, I missed that one today. What was that?
Hold on. I'll pull it back up again.
Sorry.
We're all so prepared.
Clayton Clark and Jake Painter.
Oh. Maybe I did miss that on here. Sorry about that.
I'm not familiar with Jake.
I'm not either. But
I can't say that I am either. I haven't.
I'm not a big fan of law enforcement. So
kind of looks like Nathan Fraser there.
He does. He really does. So I'm gonna go with Jake Painter.
I'm gonna go with Clayton. Bang bang.
I gotta remember which promotion we're at as to whether I like Clayton or not.
Well, at Hybrid, he's won that tournament. He's
And he put Dalton into slave ship?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He's got Dalton under wraps. He's finally figured out how to put Dalton in chains. Somebody's calling that guy down.
No fun.
But he definitely has a lot of momentum right now. I would certainly watch out for Clayton in that match.
He may have a big weekend. He may be AVW champion.
No, he is losing on Sunday. Don't make me get into this debate.
I don't know.
He's losing on Sunday.
You saw him go through two people at the last AVW show. Hurt, banged up, still made it through. Jimmy's going to have to bring his A game.
I've seen Jimmy fall off a 30-foot ladder to concrete. Clayton's nothing.
Now, to be fair, Jimmy always brings his A game. So
he does.
Oh, for sure.
It's going to be a test.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun match, period.
Well, according to the promos we got from AVW today and yesterday, It looks like Clayton won the pony. So
he does have a nice little pony there, doesn't he? That's pretty cute.
So did Jimmy. It was a little wooden rocking horse. I was saying. we're big fans of promos. We're big fans of kayfabe.
Absolutely. It just adds so much to the story. It's worth every bit of it.
And kayfabe's such a dying art. It really is. It's a dying art.
I agree.
Right. Didn't you put this up on the page this week, Reb?
What?
About kayfabe being a dying art.
I did. I kind of had a little rant of kind of fed up with dirt sheets spoiling shit before you see it on the pay-per-views, but that's neither here nor there.
I agree. You got to have that mystery to it.
Yeah.
Well, we were more upset about the whole Jacob Fatu getting hurt, and then they turn around saying, oh, he's not hurt. They just wanted to keep him and Roman away from each other. Dude, it was fine the way it was. Leave it the hell alone.
Right. Yeah. All right, so I've found the matches for Sunday, if you guys want to run through that real quick.
Of course, yeah. I've got those here as well.
Yeah, Envision Tag Team Champions.
Hold on. Stop. Oh. We have comments.
Oh, we have comments. Hang on. Who do we piss off?
We didn't piss off anybody.
Oh, everybody. Papa Pullman promos are fun to do. Hey, Papa Pullman is taking to promos like a fish to water, no pun intended.
He has. Like I said, we'll talk more about that tomorrow.
She says, I've also seen Jimmy dive off a balcony through a table and not win the match.
Yeah, he has. He didn't win the one that he fell off the 30-foot ladder either. So, yeah.
That's true. All right. So, shall we run through this real quick here?
Let's do it. Because I'm super excited about this card.
Yeah, it's a big one.
Really excited about ABW's card.
Cecil's been bringing it. I've been in two of the three shows so far, and I've enjoyed the hell out of it. Devontae Knox and Theo White, the Invasion Tag Team Champions against War Pigs. We kind of touched on that earlier.
Who you going with, Reb?
This is a title match. So I'm gonna go Trauma Unit on this one. There are guys.
You're putting me in a really bad situation because I can't agree with you.
Why not?
I can't. Because I can't go against Devontae. Come on. He won the dance-off on Friday.
And the Uno.
And Uno.
I got to imagine Devontae wins every dance-off.
He kind of does.
I've seen him in a few.
He's pretty good. Okay, wait. Who has the titles? War Pigs have the titles?
No, Trauma Unit has the titles.
Trauma Unit.
Trauma Unit? Well, then Trauma Unit's winning. Sorry. Austin, Aaron, I love you, but Crash, Burn, I love you, but no.
Title's going to be retained.
Yeah.
All right. This one, I think I know who you're picking here, Menders. Mikal Murphy versus Kid Riot.
Actually, hey, good segue. Because guess who's joining us next week? And if you... Exactly! We got Kid Riot coming on next week. So we'll be talking about his victory that happens on Sunday.
Oh, Pablo said he sucked at the debate.
He did.
He's not debate's not his strong suit. He's a dancer and an Uno player.
We're back to Devontae again. Sorry, we get off on tangents that we think. Okay, AJ says, I'll throw the X up every time Trauma Unit shows up. It's like throwing up a...
Finger.
Oh, a one finger when the bloodline is around. You got to do it. Let's get far away from the bloodline. We've got AJ. Get away from the bloodline.
Yeah.
We got to get away from that.
Anytime somebody holds a belt for more than a month, he starts going on about Roman.
Yeah.
All right. Menders
should have held it for 8 years.
I think, are we both going with Kid Riot on this one, Menders?
Oh, I'm going Kid Riot.
I don't know. You know what? Actually, Mikal's kind of on a roll, though, in AVW. Just because
it's Kid's debut, though.
Yeah, I'm thinking it's going to be Kid, but yeah. In the interest of harmony on the podcast next week, I'm not going to pick against Kid Riot.
Good call.
Good thinking.
Hey, that's how our picks end up being. It may not be who we want to win, but if they're on the pod, yep, you're winning, bud.
You don't want to make your guests mad before they show up, right?
Nope.
Okay. Right. Now, the only other match I have is the main event, which is Jimmy Carrot and Clayton Clark.
What do you have?
Yeah, oh, you may have more.
I've got the full card. All right. Okay. We've got Rico Jones versus the Cobra.
Cobra. King every day.
We about got one out of Mindy. Come on now.
Yeah, you about got it. You really did about get it. Yeah, Strike King. Strike King. Sorry, Rico. Strike King. Sorry, Rico. Not happening. Love you, kid, but DeCobra will like, everybody's talking about who's going to, like, really challenge Carrot for that belt.
I agree.
He better keep his eye out for Cobra.
For sure. DeCobra is amazing.
I've seen it before. I'd love to see it again. Let them run at it, because it's so much fun. So much fun.
I bet that's such a fast-paced match.
Oh, it's ridiculous. It's so much fun. I love those matches. All right, Reb, who's your choice? Do you even know who Rico is? Have you seen Rico?
No, but okay. I'm very familiar with the Cobra.
Sir, as you like to call him.
Sir, yes. He is Sir Status with me.
Yeah, I met Rico at a EPW show last year. Heck of a nice guy. Haven't seen him.
Oh, once, yeah.
But, yeah.
He's nice a good, he's been at Hybrid a few times. I know I've seen him at Hybrid a few times. Rico's a good kid. But again, kid, DeCobra, King.
True.
It's kind of a no-brainer for me. Just saying.
There's levels, right?
Exactly. AJ, I've seen DeCobra versus Carrot. It's a damn good match. Let them go and do what they do. It's the truth.
Seen it on video, never seen it in person. But I'm all for it.
I think I have a few videos of Carrot and DeCobra, actually. All right, what do we got next? Did you pick one, Reb?
Are you Cobra.
Okay.
Then we got Corey McHenry versus Christian Cash versus Kenneth James versus Zay Gates.
Okay, the only one that I'm familiar with there is Zay Gates, and he's impressed the hell out of me both times I've seen him. So I'm gonna go with him.
Kenneth James was at the last show.
Was he?
Yeah. He ended up getting handcuffed to Kiddo. In that four-man scramble or whatever.
Gotcha. I'm all for names.
The red hair guy.
The guy who had like the Roman gladiator outfit on.
No.
Well, I'll figure it out.
Okay.
I'm terrible with names. So
more like a Wyatt kind of outfit type deal. He had jeans.
Big guy. Oh, the big guy. Okay. I don't know who you're talking about now.
Yeah, him.
He had the beer in his briefcase.
Sure. I don't remember. But I just know he ended up being handcuffed to Tyler at the end of the match.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking of.
Yep.
Okay, we're good. I can't remember his name for the life of me.
I'm going with Gates. I'm going with Gates.
I can see that.
We're agreeing on everything again, Reb.
Damn it.
How did I end up on the episode where you guys agree? I wanted to see some turmoil.
Well, you throw Trauma Unit and the Cobra out there.
It's, oh, okay.
There's certain people that we just can't argue. Like, we both enjoy them. Now, if it would be, let's say Trust versus B.A. Malkin.
Oh.
We'd have some problems.
Yeah.
We'd have some problems. You'd
have a stroke trying to think of who you'd rather not lose.
Exactly. I wouldn't care. Double count out, belts vacant. Let's do this.
We used to call them the plane crash series. You hope both teams die on a plane on the way to the game.
Well, one of them, their nickname is the Jets. So I'm not putting them over this week.
See if I got
the said no.
No, I put him okay. So I hate
him. Put over his ability.
Put over his ability.
His personality.
I still hate him, but I put over his ability because he actually is pretty good. But I don't like him.
Mindy has spoken.
I have spoken. Understand? I have spoken. Not that it usually matters most of the time, but.
Hey, you get your point across, I'm sure.
I try, anyway.
Next, though, we got a big match. Jared Savage versus Ace Anderson.
Ooh.
I haven't seen too many people that can take Jared Savage down.
Uh-uh. I think I got to go Savage on this one.
Yeah, I'm going to say the same there.
I'm going to argue.
Let's hear it.
I'm going with Savage, or not Savage. I'm going with Anderson.
Okay.
Jared Savage spilt beer on me at the New Version Wrestling show. So he's not my favorite. Not my favorite at all.
Mr. Party Foul. We can't have that. Mm-hmm.
It was because he was taken after
Sandman?
No, it was one of the Hall guys.
Oh.
Yeah, he was taken after Chris Hulls.
Yeah, Chris. Yeah. Chris Hulls. Mm-hmm. And it was right by me, and he smashed the beer on Chris, and I was like, really?
Yep.
So I had beer all down the back of my clothes, on the back of my carrot shirt.
Well, that's what you get for wanting to sit up close and be part of the action, you know? Franchise gets a beer smashed on his head, and you're right there.
I was in the back. I was like the fourth or fifth row back.
Get your shit moving.
You're right next to the aisle.
Yeah?
Yeah, so you're part of the action.
Here's the thing, though. When we went in to go sit down, that wasn't how the last time I had been to New Version, how it was set up. The last time I've been there, they came out the side there.
Yeah.
Where those two doors were at, and not from the back. Well, front, back, whatever you want to call it. But I didn't realize we were sitting on the entry aisle when I sat down. I was like,
yeah, you had VIP seats this time.
Oh.
You got free beer.
Yeah, no, I didn't, because it was all down my back. And it was the poor guy's beer behind us. I felt bad for him, honestly.
Better his than yours, right?
Very true. Very true. All right, so we're arguing on that one.
It feels right to argue.
It does. It feels great. But I don't know. Not a big Savage fan. I don't know why. I'm just not.
Fair enough.
Maybe it was because the first time we saw him, he fought DLC.
Maybe.
That could be it. That could be part of it. All right, what's the next one?
Wasn't it?
DLC 1.
Oh, yeah? All right, up next we've got T.Y. Ice versus Jason Levi versus Jackson Morgan.
Oh, shit.
That's a good match.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Run that down again for me.
T.Y. Ice, Jason Levi, and Jackson Morgan.
Okay.
T.Y. Ice is the one that's causing all the problems on the edge.
Yep.
Or that was out in the stands.
It was one of the Cash Money Crew, whatever.
Yes. Yeah,
he was Cold Hard Cash. The goofball with the blue hair.
Yeah.
The blue hair.
The blue weenie. I remember.
Yeah. And then you know who Jason Levi is. I'm pretty sure you know who Jason Levi is. Didn't Jason Levi?
Levi fought Carrot the first show I went to.
Through the television. Yeah. Now, the other one, I'm not sure.
Jackson Morgan, he was at the last show at ABW.
He's the fellow with the apron, right? Can I understand, man?
I don't recall his entrance music.
Big hardcore guy, I think it is.
Who did he fight?
Oh, you would have to ask me that.
Sorry, that's the way I usually remember things.
Yep. I do not recall who his last match was.
Yeah, I think he's like the guy who looks like a demented butcher that comes out with the pig head and all that stuff.
Yeah, sounds familiar. Mm-hmm.
Okay. I kind of remember. Even though he was a jerk to me, I think I'm going to go with T.Y.
I'm going to go... I really want to say Jason Levi.
That's the other one I was debating about. I really like Jason Levi.
So though. I think I'm gonna say Levi, but I was tempted to go Morgan, but I'm gonna stick with Levi.
You know, I don't see T.Y. not having a little of outside.
He'll have help. He'll have help.
I'll say outside support.
Then while the two big guys are going at it, he'll figure something out.
Yep, exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's a weasel like that.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. He is. I mean. But I do adore that Jason Levi. He's a lot of fun. I like
him. He is awesome. Jason Levi, every time I've seen him, he puts on an amazing match. Puts his heart out there for sure. great to watch. You know, and that match that I saw with Jackson Morgan, that was so much fun as well. This is going to be a great match coming up. Yeah. I think so. I think you put those three in there together, you're going to get fireworks.
Well, like we said, this whole card, though, even when we've been sending the different ones that we knew about and we're sending them back and forth to each other, and we're all like, this is going to be a good, really good card, and we're excited for it.
It's going to be a lot of awesome battles.
No, it never did happen. Never did. We got promised a Jason Levi, Anakin Murphy match, and it never happened.
That's sad. That'd be a good one.
Yeah.
I think that was when Anakin went off on the crowd and said a bunch of not nice words.
Anakin, not nice? No.
Oh, these are really not nice.
Over the top, huh?
Uh-huh.
Worse than calling your mother an old bag?
Yes. He forgot it was family friendly and the F-bomb got dropped quite a bit. So, yeah. After AJ got yelled at for saying the F-word, which that's a whole other story in itself. But, okay, what we got next?
Next up is Jordan Dye versus your boy Tyler Scott.
Oof. Well, Jordan is one half. No, Jordan's got to be Joey last month. Mm-hmm. Best of the best of the best, I think, is what they call him.
The best of the best of the best. He's better than the best of the best on their best day ever.
Oh, geez.
Okay. Yeah. So he just has a high opinion of himself.
Yeah, he likes himself.
But he beat Joey.
He beat Joey.
He did, and that was a good match. That was a really fun match to watch. And they both put it all out there on that one.
Yeah.
I ended up in the cowboy hat and the cowbell.
All you're missing was the baby.
Yep, that's all I was missing was the baby. I'm going to go Die. I love Tyler, but I'm going to go Die.
You know, because I didn't pick him for the Hyber show, I'm going to pick Kiddo for this one.
Okay.
Papa Poland picking Jordan.
Hey, Kiddo knows I love him regardless, even if I don't pick him, so I ain't worried about it. It's kind of like, remember how Devontae used to be whenever he was fighting Carrot, and I had to always pick Carrot, because, you know, I wanted to. And he's like, I understand. I know you still love me. I said, I do. I just think you're going to lose. I'm sorry.
There's levels of love.
That's true. All right, what's next?
Up next, we got Anakin Murphy versus Joey O'Reilly.
Oh, interesting.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, AJ wrote a paragraph.
Okay. Yep. See, there it is. That's what it was.
I would put this up, but I think it's going to take up the whole screen.
It probably will. Yep. That's the night I yelled an F-bomb at Clayton Clark and security got mad at me for it. And then Anakin came out and said, bleep, bleep, you bleep, 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 bleep. I hope you bleep, bleep, bleep. And I had to grab the security guy and say, hey, you going to tell him that? It's the truth. I was sitting right next to AJ when that all went down. Cause I think I think Gary J was there that night. So we started our Gary F and J chant. So,
All right, so Anakin and Joey. Now, this is when we know both of these guys very well, Menders.
We do know them very well. I've got to think about this, because Trauma Unit's going to be there, too.
But, well, is the animosity going to carry over from 0-1 to AVW?
Just the thought of knowing he's in the locker room should.
Should.
Papa Pullman, you know my pick. Yeah, we know your pick.
We know your pick.
Papa Pullman
is the guy that booked you.
Dad. So, yeah. Anakin, that's Anakin Murphy's dad is Papa Pullman. So, yeah, we know his pick. Rev, you pick first, because I'm still thinking.
All right. Well, Anakin didn't book me for Friday.
But, you're still bitter about this, aren't you?
I'm telling you, my idea worked.
Come I know.
On. Thumb wrestling would have fit right in.
It would.
But I'm going to go with Joey on this. He made a very good impression on the audience last month when they were there.
Now I'm curious. Is Garfield going to be joining Anakin?
I don't. He might still be recovering from the match on Friday.
He might be.
I mean, so... Jacques caught Garfield good in that drop kick.
Yeah, I know he did. Or they did. I think I'm going to go with Anakin, actually. I think I'm going to side with Papa Pullman on this one.
Are you going to wear your Anakin Murphy merchandise?
Who's on the card?
Oh, yeah, I forgot. Never mind.
Exactly.
She got Trauma Unit, War Pigs, Joey O'Reilly, Jimmy Carrot, all those on the card. I mean, so much other merch to pick from first. Right?
She should have like 8 t-shirts on, just peel one off for each match. And then
I'm not doing that. It'll be way too hot because I actually...
You're always cold.
Well, they've got outside restroom access there. Just go change it for each match.
Hey, those bathrooms are pretty sharp.
Those are nice bathrooms.
Well, that whole facility is nice.
That's yes. Really cool. And the food. Did you have the food when you were there?
I did not have the food. Well, you should. I showed up and I really got into business and I didn't have the chance to go check out the kitchen, but I'm going to next time for sure.
Actually, all of those guys, I think I only have 4 total shirts. 5 out of everybody that we've said so far. I think I only have 5 shirts. But that's only 5 people because, you know, you can't count how many shirts I have for Carrot because that's kind of unfair.
Every 2 minutes in Carrot's match, you're going to put a different.
No, not doing that because I'm not missing any of the match. So, sorry about you.
All right. So, I'm picking Joey. You're picking Anakin on that one. Then. Yep.
I'm going to go with Deathwish. Although, Anakin will have Christian Rose will be there. So, I don't know how much Christian Rose still messes with him. So, and that's from Anarchy stuff. So, we'll see. All right. What's the next one?
That actually takes us down to, you know, the main event, which we talked about, was Jimmy Carrot and Clayton Clark.
Jimmy Carrot.
You know, Clayton's a scrapper, but.
Wait, is Limbo going to be there?
I did not see his name on the card, but that doesn't mean he won't be. He does show up when Jimmy shows up.
Minion, so.
Yeah.
Clayton Basil could
be in double trouble there.
Yeah, Basil will be there. Ah, there's nothing to worry about. Basil will be there. It'll be fine.
As long as those hellions on the in the audience don't try to steal Basil and tear him apart.
Give Basil to me. I'll take care of Basil. Wouldn't it be the first time.
Mm-hmm. It's true. I gotta go Jimmy. You know, he's the champ. But
I'm not saying that Clayton won't give him a run for his money.
It'll be a hell of a match.
Yeah, I'm really excited about the match. I'm not saying that he wouldn't give him a run for his money. Jimmy's just better. Clayton's good. I'm not saying Clayton's not, but Jimmy's better.
I see Clayton told me you would say this too.
I figured he did.
He's like, Mindy's such a hater. She's gonna go with Jimmy.
Yeah.
There's a shirt for Jimmy. He should make one says blank is good, but Jimmy's better.
Yep. No, last time we made a shirt, he uses it. He wears it all the time.
Well, I heard a handful of people with the last AVW show saying they wanted the shirt.
Oh, the Jimmy Carrot.
The Jimmy Carrot will not die shirt. Yeah.
Yeah, awesome. I wish we get credit for that one.
We?
You? I was the one that sent it to him.
That's true.
Team effort.
It's there's no I in team, Enders.
There's a me, though.
There's an eye in merchandise. I'm kidding.
No. There is. Speaking of, all right, we've kept Jeremy for quite a while.
We appreciate you making the time to hang out with us tonight, Jeremy.
Well, thank you, guys. I really appreciate you having me on. This has been a blast. My first podcast ever. I feel like...
it's your first one?
Yeah, my first podcast ever. This has been great.
Don't worry. It's ours.
Thank you for having me.
What's it been, Reb? 3 years now since you've had your first one?
I just hit 3 years last week since the first one of these. So,
it's awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.
He's the one that's been on here the longest, and then he kind of brought me on. Originally, I was just a 01 correspondent. I went from his Mike Tenay of 01 to being on the show all the time.
You were the Mike Tenay of 01.
Now you guys are Laurel and Hardy.
We pretty much are.
Echo and Jekyll, however you want to look at it.
That there, James F. Carrot is hottest thing since sliced bread, and he'll keep that belt, I tell you what. Yeah, he's a few drinks in.
Yeah, when he starts quoting Hank Hill, then...
Yeah, he's a few in.
Yeah.
All right, thank you so much, Jeremy.
We'll see you this weekend, sir.
And Sunday.
Absolutely. Everybody don't forget, we've got Hybrid on Saturday and ABW on Sunday. I'll see you all there. Thanks so much for having me, guys.
Try not to call me out at this one, okay?
Or if you do, use your working name.
Well, yeah, see, like I wasn't going to call her out, but now I've got to come up with something big now that she's home.
No, it was so funny because when you came out and I even looked at Rep and I said, did he just call me out?
Oh, yep. Yeah.
Damn it. That's I can't the problem. Go anywhere.
I'm starting to get to know all the faces in the crowd now, so everybody's going to start getting a little razzing.
And that's always the best, though.
Yes.
Yeah, it really
I
is.
I have fun with it.
Yeah. All right, so we'll see you Saturday and Sunday, so we will check you later.
Absolutely. Thanks a lot, guys. Have a good night.
Thank you.
That was fun.
That was fun.
All right. Well, Menders, let's say we pay some bills real quick, and then we'll get into, we got a Top 10 Tuesday to talk about, and we still haven't talked a whole lot about Raw yet.
We haven't talked about a whole lot of anything that's on our schedule.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's pay some bills real quick here. All right, we are back, and Menders, let's get into some of the stuff we saw last night on Monday Night Raw. Got a little bit more build up for the Berlin show on the 31st.
Hold up, can I do some personal business real quick?
Do we have breaking news?
It's not really breaking news.
Okay.
Well, it doesn't have anything to do with wrestling.
Okay.
But you know Michelle.
Mitchell?
My Mitchell. Yeah, my Mitchell. Okay. Her son just had his pitching debut and struck out 2 batters.
Hey, nice.
He's 8.
Hey.
How fun is that? He's so
That's cool. Awesome.
I'm sorry.
What's his name?
Jacob.
Hey, congratulations, Jacob.
Yeah.
About to call him Ace.
Right? But anyway, okay, back to Raw.
Yes, so last week...
You got to start at the beginning, because we've got an intergender match that's coming up.
We'll hit the high spots here.
Okay.
Starts off, we didn't get anything from Dominic or Liv last week, as far as an explanation for what went down. But we got a pretty fun exchange with those two and Rhea on the microphone at the start.
I missed part of it, because I didn't tune in until like 10 after.
Okay.
But I saw the important part, so.
Yeah, I liked the priest reveal right behind them on the at the top of the stairs.
You knew it was coming.
Come on. Oh, yeah, absolutely. So that's, we're getting that, we're going to get the intergender match, Priest and Rhea against Dom and Liv.
Now, how do you feel about this intergender match with it not being like a mixed match tag team tournament or anything like that? How are you feeling about this?
I mean... It's not like your intergender matches where it's a free-for-all. This is still going to be...
Is that going to be the same rule? I don't...
Yeah.
Here's the thing.
I prefer it's a free-for-all, but, you know...
Liv
and Priest is kind of a mismatch.
Well, then that's their fault.
Dom and Rhea is kind of a mismatch.
Again, that's their fault. I like the Twin Terrors or whatever they're...
Terror Twins.
I like the Terror Twins. I wish they didn't make it to where if Dominic tags Liv in, then you got to bring in Rhea. I'd rather it be, you know, if you're willing to step on the mat and be in that match, then you're willing to fight whoever is across from you.
I agree.
We all know why they're doing this match. You're paying your price of admission to see Rhea give Dom the riptide with that one.
Pretty much.
Yeah, pretty much.
And also for Liv to go through some sort of table.
Yes, please.
Let's see. We got another comment.
Papa.
Yeah. Dom versus Morgan and Priest versus Ripley would be more even.
It really would.
So we got to talk about in the build up to the Orton Gunther match, we got a visit from Drew. And I almost gave Kathy Kelly my good Judy of the week if we were going to go with the Judy Martin route, because she was on an airplane with Punk and didn't stooge it off to anybody that he was, that he wasn't having travel issues.
I was so proud of her. I was so proud of her. I was like, that's my girl, kayfabe. Hell yeah. So proud of her. She's like, yeah, I sat next to you. I was like, well, you know, if I said I was here, I was like, I get it.
So we got the Drew Punk fracas at ringside. I have a picture here, Menders. I don't know if you've seen this yet or not, but Drew posted a picture of his back after the whipping from
let's Punk. See it. I haven't seen it. Well, I think we're getting a strap match in Berlin.
Yeah. That's what I said. As soon as they had, I was like, are we getting a strap match?
That was the same thing I said too. I was like, I guess we're getting a strap match. And then even Punk said, holding the belt, I think I have an idea for Berlin. I was like, gosh, dang it. Why do we got to pay such close attention?
Well, why also, the thing is, this, I think, is a logical next step, because I'm still think that, well, before Seth was taking time off, I thought that they're going to blow off their feud at Hell in a Cell in October at the Bad Blood pay-per-view.
Oh, I still think we're getting the Cell. I still think we're getting the Cell at Bad Blood.
After the Cell now.
You don't think so?
I don't know. I mean, they got to, what are they going to do with Punk between that and whenever Seth comes back? Because I think Seth's gone for the rest of the year.
Oh, I didn't realize he was out for that long.
I think he's taking time away. I don't know that for sure. I have to check. AJ.
AJ. Where's our fact check? Oh, wait. You forget. He's like six in.
Oh, Sammy.
Huh?
Sammy.
Sammy. Murder Panther. I didn't realize he was going to be gone for that long. So if that's the case, yeah, they're going to need to draw that out.
Unless they get somebody else for Punk.
Or Punk's going to need to have somebody else to mess with. I still think we're getting Rollins and CM Punk at WrestleMania.
Yeah, that's a given. I think even if Seth wasn't hurt, that's what we were going to be getting.
Wait, breaking kayfabe. That's what was reported. That's what Bari said.
What?
I don't know. He said breaking kayfabe, and then he said that's what was reported, was that Seth was out till the end of the year.
Oh.
I'm assuming that's what he's talking about anyway.
For breaking kayfabe?
I don't know.
It's not like Roman and Braun sightseeing in Rome together when they were in the middle of a feud.
I see, because I don't know who else you put with. The only thing is, not taking time off. He's injured.
He is hurt. Okay. So.
Well, I heard he had internal bruising.
Well, they were selling broken ribs from the attack on from Bronson.
Which I'm glad they were, because that makes the most sense. But
yeah.
Go for it. Does that mean R-Truth is out now till the end of the year? I hope not. He's my
comment. I wonder if, are we going to get Truth in like a neck brace and a wheelchair and
okay,
like that traction, might be, like Cardona?
That might be, no, because then somebody's going to wheel him off the, well, no. Oh, wait, no, because it's not up anymore. Okay.
Truth might take a wrong turn and roll himself off the side of the stage.
He probably would.
Oh, my bad, dog.
My bad, dog. All right.
I did enjoy the backstage, though, after they showed Miz the Miz, like, isn't that the guy that killed Seth? And then Orton comes, isn't that the guy that killed Rollins?
Yeah. And Miz is like, oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness.
I did like the fact that Miz actually came out to his music instead of them rapping when he came out by himself.
Well, it wasn't an awesome Truth match.
I know, but I'm still saying I enjoyed that part.
True.
don't mention a national treasure like Truth in the same breath as a little like piece of trash like
Madonna. I hit a touchy subject with our buddy AJ.
You did. Careful.
Uh-huh.
You don't talk about Mick Cardona with AJ. That don't work.
Hasty subject change. How do we feel about another three-way tag team title match on Raw because they couldn't decide on a number one contender?
It's the women's. I'm not gonna.
I do like that. It's Kyrie and Neo as a team.
Who's the face?
This is Damage Control, technically.
See, that's what I don't get. Who do you want us to believe is the face? Because you have a Damage Control, and then you have whatever Sonya's group calling them.
The fucking damn it! I forget the name of the something collective.
And then you have.
Then you get Alba and Isla.
See, here's the thing. I will call her Kaylee Ray until the day I die because that's the way I remember her. But who is legitimately the heel in this?
Legitimately, it's Shayna and Zoe.
It's all of them.
Alba and Isla seem like they've been tweeners almost for the last few weeks.
And so is Damage Control right now.
Io and Kyrie they've been getting the sympathetic reactions, though, from getting jumped in the back and beaten down. Dakota got hurt, all that stuff. See, Papa Pomo says you don't have to have a face.
Yes, you do. I don't care what the match is. You need a face. You need somebody that somebody's rooting for in order for people to care about it. Sorry, that's just my take.
Oh, if you have a name, I'm not saying this.
Okay, I'm back.
Okay.
I lost it.
Almost.
Almost. We almost got it.
We talked about the 2 out of 3 match earlier when we were talking about our good hoots. Great showcase for Braun.
Such a good match.
Yeah.
Hey, and it didn't do anything to hurt Sammy either.
No.
Really didn't.
Sammy's Teflon. He is. He's bulletproof right now.
But now I think I know we're going to get Judgment Day versus Jay and Sammy.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how I feel about that.
Here's a feeling Priest is going to do something to fuck the boys over.
Well, I don't see the Judgment Day as the power that they were anymore. I just don't.
I think they need to get the tag belts off of Finn so they can really push him again as a single star. Which they can't do.
I read Papa Pullman's message.
Because, well, I mean, if they're going to put the tag belts on him, and I like Finn and JD as a tag team, but if they're going to push Finn as like, not the leader, they said there's no leaders, but as the heavyweight contender in the group, then he can't be in a tag team.
I agree.
Papa says Braun versus Bronson. Breaker or Strowman versus Bronson? Too many Brauns and Bronsons on the Raw roster.
He means Braun Strowman. And
Braun Strongman?
Yeah, Braun Strongman versus Braun.
That'd be, I'm okay with it. Big hoss bite. They gotta put Bronson over.
Honestly, I think it's gonna be Reed.
Yeah.
I really think it's gonna be Reed.
Oh, for the belt. So Bronson and Breaker.
Wait, are you talking Reed? Or are you talking?
Oh, AJ double down. Braun versus Braun. The winner keeps his name.
Well, yeah, winner keeps his name. Braun versus Braun versus Bronson. All right, cool. Let's do this.
Sounds like an R&B group.
It does.
Like Tony, but Bronson. You don't have to call me Bronson.
I don't know. I don't know how I feel. I don't know how I feel about all of it. I really don't.
I need to see more.
Yeah. I need to see more. I want to see now where they're going with Wyatt Six.
I'm curious.
I'm really curious on that. Because obviously they didn't make an appearance last night, but no, they had video. The
video. Yeah.
They had the video that said where Uncle Howdy was proud, which totally get it. But
Uncle Prouty.
That was terrible. Question. How do you feel about how Xavier Woods is responding to Odyssey Jones?
It's kind of what sort I'm looking for? Transparent.
It really is. He's not happy.
It seems like they're angling for the heel turn, but I could also see it where it's going to be a bait and switch, and it's going to be some sort of a ruse.
I mean, I feel the breakup coming. I'm not stupid.
I thought it was going to happen. It should have happened when Kofi won the title.
I did too.
That's when I thought, I thought Xavier should have been the one to break away.
Well, and he kind of did. Because that was when he became the King of the Ring, though.
Yeah, but he was still a member of the New Day, though.
He was, but he kind of broke away and had his own thing, because then he was the king, and Kofi was under him.
Until Roman stole his crown and smashed it and beat him up.
Exactly.
So I'm curious where this is going to go. I'm fully expecting a heel turn, but...
Oh, me too.
I mean, if it was Vince, he wouldn't dream of breaking those guys up.
Is he going to join Cross and them?
I hope not. If he breaks up, I hope he goes solo. Why would he leave a group to go to another group?
I mean, that's what they seem to be pushing for.
I think that's what they're teasing. That doesn't mean it's going to happen, though.
Let's hope, but we all know how this works out usually.
Well, we know how it worked out with Vince. I'm not sure how... Hunter hasn't had this situation, really.
We'll see. Are we going to talk about that god-awful show that I watched last week?
Dynamite?
Yeah, that one.
Oh. The one you got through like half of before you gave up?
Oh, I gave up. So gave up. Did you hear about the ratings?
No.
622,000. They started at 8:52.
Sheldon's not helping no more.
Actually, okay, it was 8:52 for the... I'm going off of memory because I listened to it today. I think it was 8:52.
Oh, we got a new drive-thru?
Yeah. Well, it's up on YouTube. I don't know if you guys got it yet. Because he did a breakdown of the ratings. Literally in the first hour, they dropped almost 200,000 viewers.
Tony.
It starts at like, I think it's like 8:22 or 8:52 or something along those lines. And by the end of the show, it's like 5:13.
Oh.
Yeah, it's bad.
Hurts my parts.
Here's the bad part. That last match, I didn't get to it because I couldn't stand what I was already watching.
What was the last match?
It was Danielson and Jarrett.
Oh, Jarrett. The Anything Goes Fuckery match.
And they lost like 30,000 viewers. It's like... That's all right. Did we get a... Okay. Collision was fun.
I'll bet that bull rope match was good.
Collision was only like 198,000 people, though. It was really low.
And dozens in the arena.
Dozens. Hey, what'd you think about seeing Mark Henry?
Hey, how about that? I didn't realize that Jake was that big.
Holy crap, he's huge!
He's bigger than Mark, almost.
Yes!
I was surprised he didn't get booed, because he goes to Oklahoma, and they were in Texas.
Well, yeah, but he's in the, what, the NIL?
NIL program.
Yeah, the NIL program.
The name, image, likeness thing, so he can get paid by WWE while he's going to college.
No, it's next in line, is what they're saying it is.
Oh, okay. Whatever.
In other words, they're being trained, and then they'll go to NXT, and then they'll...
Right. Mark was on Busted Open, and they were asking about that. Apparently, the plan is the kid's not going to wrestle till he's done with school. And I'm not exactly sure. I think he's 19 or 20, so I think he may be a sophomore.
So a couple years.
But he's going to go train at the New Japan Dojo in California first.
Oh, damn. Okay.
he's because Mark said he wants him to learn like you would learn doing the territories. So he's going to go to the dojo first, then he's going to go to Rip Rogers.
Isn't that what Sam Knight did?
I think so, yeah.
Wasn't he at Rip Rogers?
And then he's going to go to TJ and Natty's camp.
Oh.
And then he's going to go to the PC. So he's going to learn everything. He's not learning just the WWE style.
I really miss Tyson. I really do.
Yeah. He was so good.
I went back and I've been watching some old NXT.
Yeah.
So I watched the Adrian Neville versus Sami Zayn. Earlier in that whole night was one CJ Parker.
Juice
versus KO.
Oh, that's when Juice broke his nose.
Yep, it was. And then KO turned on Sammy and about broke his neck. So yep. Yeah, it was a good time. Oh,
stiff ass apron powerbomb.
And you know who I didn't notice until when I watched it the other day? Samantha was the ring announcer.
Was she?
She was.
She's been there that long?
Yeah, she has.
I'll be darned.
So that's like almost 10 years.
That's like 9 years, yeah. She's been there longer than Ricochet.
Yeah. Well, he's gone now, so yeah. Oh. But she was there before Ricochet.
I'll be darned.
Yep. I was real, when I saw, I was like, holy crap, that's Samantha. Yeah, so she was at NXT first.
Yeah.
Because that was, there were some interesting matches during that one.
I loved NXT back then.
Oh, I did.
Is that the one where it was Balor and Kenta against the Ascension?
Yes.
I thought so. And there's when Balor debuted the Demon?
Yes.
Yeah.
I miss the Demon. I wish he'd bring the Demon back.
I'll bet he'll be back.
I really hope so.
I think he'll bring him back for the whatever the big match is with Priest.
I hope so.
Yeah. All right. So I got a question for you, Menders.
Yes?
Just in your opinion. I mean, everybody has an opinion. I think we probably have the same opinion.
Okay.
Because we were talking about the Judgment Day. If you put the new in front of a stable, is that the kiss of death for wrestling gimmicks?
It really because is.
Think back to really the new is. Midnight Express.
Yep.
Which was Bodacious Bob and Bombastic Bart, I believe, of Holly Bart Gunn. With the new Rockers.
So first of all, there's your first problem. If you can't remember who was in it, then obviously it didn't work.
I remember who was in it. I just can't remember which one was Bodacious and which was Bombastic.
Again, if you can't remember.
It's a tongue twister.
Well, it's still a kiss of death. I think if you're gonna change whatever the faction is, I think you need a new name.
I agree. Because
why do you want to be? However, there is one. There's one exception to that rule.
Don't say the New Day.
No, because they already have New in their name. So what are you gonna do?
You can't have the New Day and the New Judgment Day in the same show.
No. More of what I was thinking was when they wanted to do Bullet Club. And
in AEW?
No, when they were trying to do it at one, they weren't really doing it. They just put OG OC. When it was, or OC, when it was AJ,
Gallows and Anderson. They were
like,
the club first.
And that's fine, but I feel like Bullet Club is something that I know New Japan's not as well known as the bigger companies, but I feel like the Bullet Club is something that is kind of worldwide known.
Bullet Club is mainstream more than New Japan is.
Right. So I feel like if you go Bullet Club, and as much as I hate to say it, I think it was the Young Chucks that made that happen. I know, I hate to admit it, but I think that's what made it happen because there were a lot of people that knew who the Young Bucks or the Young Cucks were, but they didn't necessarily know. They didn't know, like, they didn't realize AJ Styles was part of the Bullet Club. They didn't realize that it was Prince Devitt. They didn't realize there were a lot of things that people didn't realize that were part of it.
There's also the people that saw the logo and thought that there was like an ISIS group.
Right.
This was just machine guns and the font and everything, and no mention of wrestling whatsoever on it.
And then when you think of how many different subgenres they had.
You got the Elite. You got the Elite.
You
got more of them now than back then, because you got the War Dogs, you got the House of Torture, you got Bullet Club Gold, which I don't know if that's even still used now. I think they've just gone to Bang Bang Gang or whatever it is.
Yeah. Or then like the Elite. Wasn't there like Violent or Violence or Villains? Villains.
The Villain Club. Well, that was just for t-shirts. That was just.
Well, I know, but it's.
Each guy got the t-shirt, but they put their thing above club on the stuff.
But how are you making merch? It's because people knew who the Bullet Club was and knew they were a part of it.
Yeah. Plus the guys that just thought, hey, that's a cool looking shirt. I'm just going to buy that.
And that was more where I was at, because I was like, I kind of like the skull. I'm not going to lie.
Hey, but it's a cool shirt. I got like two of them.
Any team Gallows and Anderson are involved in are the Hoots, because Big Hoot and Little Hoot got to find a new leader Hoot. Me and Barry decided years ago, that's Hoot and Hoot and Hoot.
I'm sorry. When I think of Hoot, I think of Robert Gibson. Punky Morton, Hoot Gibson. But yeah, so I've heard rumors that they're going to change the Judgment Day's name, which I think they should do.
I think they should, because in all honesty, when I think Judgment Day, I think Edge, Damian, and Rhea.
Yeah.
And that's who I think.
Mm-hmm. So they're going to have those guys are interlopers.
Yeah, they were the ones that jumped in later. Mm-hmm. I look at the original group, and with nobody from the original group still in it, they need to change it completely.
How do you feel about the rumors that they're going to be called Street Trash?
Go for it.
I don't like it.
See? Well, I don't think
Enterprises wasn't Bullet Club, though. They were just, that was just after Marty was left after all the other Elite guys went to AEW.
Okay. Well, see, that was where I was going, because I enjoyed his shirt. I really liked his shirt.
Yeah.
But I don't think they need to be still Judgment Day. I think they need to come up with something different and step away from it completely. New Jumbotron, new whatever. New color. What?
New colors.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think if we can come up with an acronym with all of their like first initials.
There are no vowels in that. How are we going to come up with that?
F J C D and L, the Juggadol. No.
No. Sorry. I've got a dirty mind. I don't know. They need to come up with something else. I don't like Street Trash.
Street Trash is a bad idea.
That's
more of a priest thing. That's what Gunther was called, priest.
And you already have the Street Profits. So why would you want to do that?
You got everybody except for Liv is international. Well, Dom, technically, he's from San Diego. But...
No, but I think they can come up with something different. They need to come up with something different.
I'm going to try something here.
Uh-oh. Reb's thinking. This is a terrible idea.
Thinking.
Where's our whiteboard when we need it?
It's over there, but I don't have it mounted. I'm using Meta AI. Name.
Oh, good lord. I'm interested to see how this turns out.
I'm very curious about this.
I really am.
Say something while I'm typing, so it's not just dead air.
I had to take a drink. I'm sorry. I don't know what they need to be. Because did you catch that Balor's going by Backstabber Balor now?
I think that's more just a nickname, but yeah.
No, that's just him. But why don't they do like? I don't know. Final Testament. They have that.
Knives out.
Huh?
Knives out.
No knives out. Because you got kids that might be wearing this stuff, so you don't want one that says Knives Out. AJ, you're good at this.
Okay, here's... Okay.
Oh, there you go. I like Barry's answer. I like Barry's answer. On. He has Liv Morgan and the Lost Boys.
Okay, so Meta AI gave me 5 suggestions.
Okay.
All right. I don't know how I feel about all of these. Okay, number one, the Shadow Syndicate. And that's, it gives it explanations, too. This name plays off the dark and edgy personas of Finn Balor and J.D. McDonagh while also incorporating the mysterious and elusive qualities of the other members.
You know what? Shadow Syndicate might not be terrible. Liv Morgan presents. I don't hate that, actually.
Okay. Number two, La Familia Oscura.
No.
This name, which translates to the Dark Family in Spanish, highlights the stable's diverse membership and suggests a strong bond between its members.
Here's my problem. We have enough Spanish factions right now.
Yes, I agree. Okay, number three, the Renegades.
No.
Not without Lorenzo Lamas.
No.
This name emphasizes the stable's rebellious and unconventional nature, which aligns with the personas of Finn Balor, Liv Morgan, and Carlito.
Why don't they just call them the Rebels?
That's a little too easy. But number four, the Covenant.
No.
That sounds like one of the rejected names that they sent to the New Day when they started.
That sounds like one of the rejected names that they sent to American Horror Story. That's too. What that sounds like.
Here's their reasoning. This name suggests a sense of unity and shared purpose among the stable's members while also hinting at a darker, more mysterious agenda.
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
Okay. The number five. Okay, they use this in AEW, the Outcasts.
Nope, can't do
this
that
name
one.
Plays off the idea that the stable's members are misfits and outsiders who have found a sense of belonging and purpose together. That's just begging for a lawsuit.
But in my opinion, they're not outcasts. I don't think they're outcasts.
No, they were all hired. They were cast. They're in casts.
I hate you.
AJ says, only call them the Renegades if they can secure the copyright to that old The Renegade Who Had It Made Retrieved for a Bounty song.
Okay.
I don't want to hear Corny sing that.
Actually, Shadow Syndicate has actually probably been my favorite out of all those.
That one's actually not bad.
Yeah, I don't mind that one. I don't know. Yeah, I think new anything. Like, New Day, I totally understand. Like, that one's fine.
That's not something old that they're making new again. Like, the New Rockers was awful.
Well, like, okay, but with New Day, too. When they first came out, they tried to have that religious, like, whole ordeal. Because remember, they used to have, like, the choir or whatever clapping them out and everything. So, I totally understand that. But, yeah, I don't like New Judgment Day. No. I mean, honestly, it was already the New Judgment Day when they kicked out Edge and put in Finn.
Pretty much. That'd be like if Mark Briscoe started teaming up with Wes Briscoe and they were the New Briscoes.
No. Mm-mm. FBM.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Is there steam coming out? I can't see with your headphones.
Yeah, the steam is being held inside my head right now.
Papa Pone says Unity. But they'd have to license the Queen Latifah song.
Yeah.
AJ says, Shadow Syndicate makes me think of the Assassin's Creed game that took place in London, and that's Will Ospreay's gig. If you're going that route, call him Black Flag.
Okay.
That's not bad either.
I don't mind Black Flag.
That's not bad.
No, it's not.
Plus, I like the band, so, you know. Henry Rollins.
All right.
Henry freaking Rollins and Blackfoot.
Henry freaking
Rollins. All right. Well, Menders, let's get to our top 10 this month.
Was that everything? Was that really everything?
The only thing we didn't talk about was Roman, but, I mean, we can talk about that anytime.
It's back. I mean, what more do you need to talk about?
Pretty much. And he's going after the pepper necklace of Solo Sikoa, and, you know. I don't want to mispronounce the actual names. I don't want to seem disrespectful.
What is it called? Let me
say. It's like the ala fala or something like that.
Send it to me. I'll say it.
I'm terrible at
pronouncing stuff.
Hey, oh, I know.
did you get my Rampage?
I did. I still have to post it. But okay. Well, I know we got it because I filmed it.
I meant, did you have it up on?
Oh no, it's not up yet, but okay. it'll go up. All right, so let's throw. I wish somebody would use that music for something. All right. Top 10 Tuesday, La Macarena. That's a great tune.
Okay.
Not to be confused with that god-awful dance number from the 90s.
Right?
All right. Well, Minders, our subject this week, I think, was appropriate considering our guest.
I thought so, too.
And Papa, I think it's one we haven't done yet.
It. Papa Pullman, that was at the beginning. You totally missed it.
We did the 10 bells at the open of the show.
10 bells salute at the beginning of the show.
All right. But anyway, our topic this week, Minders, greatest ring announcers. So
here's the problem. I'm not even sure I know 10.
I didn't go like prior to like 1975.
I'm still not sure if I know 10. Like off the top of my head, I'm not sure I know 10. But it's okay because you put this list together. So
it's really on me.
But what do we have next week? What is next week?
Next week is the PWI flashback.
Ah, okay. Then the following week is the watch along.
Okay, right. Got it. And then I think that's also Thursday we're doing the full watch along for my birthday.
Crap, we gotta come up with two watch alongs?
Right, well, I got the one for the Thursday. The full show is gonna be SummerSlam 92.
Well, I knew which one that one was.
So we gotta think of a match for the Tuesday watch along.
Whose turn is it? I think it's yours.
Is it mine?
I think so, because okay. I think I picked Austin for the last one. Austin and maybe Duggan?
You did pick, I think we had another one after that, though.
Oh, did we?
Oh.
All right.
Oh, AJ. Vivian the Simps. No.
Vivian the Simps.
Oh, Stacey hates that song, by the way.
Ah, Michelle and I sing it karaoke.
Vinny and the Jets.
Yep, Michelle and I sing karaoke all the time.
I think my nephew likes it because his name's Benny.
Hey, you know what? I'm going to do one quick thing before you get into this top 10 network or top 10. We need to wish a happy birthday to DJ today because today's DJ's birthday.
Yes, DJ's birthday. She's three. Yeah, happy birthday to DJ. Full name, Delaney, I believe.
Delaney Joe.
Delaney Joe, yep. The
three.
Yes. We were talking about Joey O'Reilly for
and
Sunday.
She loves me.
Oh, she's a good kid.
She's a good Judy.
She is. We could have given her good Judy for this week if it wasn't for Judy Martin.
I was say the who we gave it to this week was kind of perfect.
Yeah. So. All right. Well, happy birthday to DJ. So
let's do this.
Yeah. All right. Number 10. I'm going to the NWA from the 70s and 80s for this one. Truck and Tom Miller. If you watched Starcades from the 80s or any shows from the Greensboro Coliseum, that he was the guy.
Aww. Look at the chat.
Oh.
That's so adorable.
He's a giver, that Papa
He's
Pullman.
He's a giver, that Papa Pullman.
So yeah, I don't know how familiar we are with Tom Miller, Menders, but yeah, all the notable moments in like Starcades.
I'm getting there because I've started going back and watching some of the stuff from NWA. So
he was pretty much the guy until they got Gary Capetta. Oh shit, Gary Capetta! I didn't put him. All right, I'm changing up my number 9 for Gary Capetta. I don't have a picture.
Okay.
But I have to because he's the guy I think of when I think of War Games.
Okay.
My apologies to Gary Capetta. I hope he's not watching this and he's not offended. So, and also apologies to MLJ from GCW for getting bumped. But
nope, sorry.
Damn it, I'm kicking myself. I'll put a nice picture of Gary up on our Facebook page after the show's over. All right, number 8. I'm going with the Dapper Yapper here, Justin Roberts. Mostly from his work in WWE. Although, I do appreciate that he's willing to admit when something's a shit show on an AEW pay-per-view.
He is. And
he looks good. He's a sharp-dressed man, to borrow from Robert Leach, who sadly is not on the list. Probably going to get me more heat with Rob.
I'm glad I don't have to answer to that one. I almost broke copyright infringement, maybe. I don't know if it's copyright infringement. When we were introducing Jeremy.
Oh, no, gimmick infringement.
There we go. I still can't believe we're getting Joey versus Anakin. Okay.
Yeah, I didn't know that. That's a nice surprise.
I didn't either. All right.
All right.
Are we at 7?
Number seven. Going the TNA route, I'm going JB, Jeremy Borden. Okay. I always liked his ring announcing.
Okay.
AJ made a good point. Justin does a good job of keeping the crowd hyped and loud during commercial breaks for AEW. He really does. He's a pretty darn good MC.
When you consider what he has to deal with.
When he smiles, he looks like a South Park character, though. Because it's like that open mouth, toothy grin where he looks like Randy Marsh when he thinks he has the right answer on Wheel of Fortune.
Okay.
Guys, you know where I'm going with that.
I do.
Uh-huh, and I'm not through with that.
All right, move on.
Who annoy me? And that's as far as I'll go. Yes, number six. Tony Chimmel, SmackDown. Okay. The guy who cannot say the rated R superstar without his voice cracking like Peter Brady. But he put the time in.
He did.
He was the voice of SmackDown for long damn time.
Sorry, I had to take a drink.
No, you're fine. All right, number five here. Menders going to the WCW route. David Penzer.
I remember him.
Yeah. He was also in TNA. Mm-hmm. Like he was their pay-per-view ring announcer. And JB would do the main event, but Penzer did the rest of the shows.
Gotcha.
Also known for being the guy that Jericho ripped the jacket off of when he started throwing temper tantrums on Nitro.
No, yeah, that was all the time, right?
Well, once he started losing, when he turned heel.
Huh? I don't know what you mean. Why, when he started losing, would he throw temper tantrums?
What?
The whole learning tree bit. It's
over it?
I'm so done.
I was over it before it started.
Here's the thing. They have one of my favorite guys that came up from ROH.
Mm-hmm.
And have destroyed him.
Okay, AJ, I will take this under advisement. If you've seen Lucha Underground, Melissa Santos will be at number five. Is that Brian Cage's wife?
Oh, I have no idea.
Melissa Santos?
Yeah, she was really good. She was really good. She had to run out of that ring a few times.
Yeah. I will point out Samantha Irvin did not make my list.
I'm so mad at you right now. I was going to ask where she was at. I'm so mad at you right now.
Give her a couple more years and she'll be on there. But I do enjoy the hell out of her work, though.
I love her.
She is a delight.
She's awesome. She's been there, what? What did we decide?
10 9 years.
9 years?
If she started in 2015.
It was 2014.
Ah, so 10 years.
She's been there 10 years. I didn't start watching NXT till 2014.
Not counting the reality show.
The first one I saw, not counting the reality show. First one I saw, though, was Sami Zayn and Neville. That was the pay-per-view we were talking about earlier, or the Redemption, something like that.
Revolution.
It was one of those.
It's one of those, yeah. Yep. Neither here nor there. Maybe we'll do an NXT watch along one of these days.
Ooh! Do we want to be a short one?
We'll discuss later.
Okay.
Number four. I went with Lillian Garcia.
I love Lillian.
She took a little bit of time to get to grow on me. Kind of like Michael Cole.
Yeah.
She had one of my favorite ring announcer moments ever, though, when she introduced Triple H as the former world heavyweight champion, and then he ran down the ramp and chased her into the stands because he was offended.
Lillian is so talented at a whole bunch.
She's very talented. That's why I really liked her podcast that she had. Chasing Glory, I believe it was called.
Yep, it was Chasing Glory.
AJ says, yes, she is Brian Cage's wife, talking about Melissa Santos. She did a good, damn good job the first three seasons of Lucha Underground as ring announcer. Season four, she was pregnant and brought in multiple guest ring announcers because she wasn't every taping. Blame Brian Cage for that.
We will. Don't worry.
All right.
She was a lot of fun, though, at Lucha Underground. She was good.
I'm sure she was. All right. Number three, Ring of Honor. I got a soft spot for Bobby Cruz. He's so good.
Makes sense.
He was the only guy that introduced Japanese talent properly in Ring of Honor.
Oh, yeah.
Because he would do it last name first. which is how they do it in Japan. So, like, Kenta Kobashi was Kobashi Kenta.
Yeah, see, and I just skip the first name all together and just go, you know, like, Ishii!
Like he would say, Shibata Tashiyori.
Shipoopy, shipoopy,
shipoopy. Damn it, that's all in my head now.
Sorry, couldn't resist.
I know. All right, number two, going to ECW menders, Bob Ortiz.
Okay. I've been watching some ECW, so yeah. I know who that is now.
Did you watch Anarchy Rules 99?
Not yet.
Okay, when you do, he has a significant role in the pre-match for one of the big the matches you'll enjoy.
Okay.
Do you want me to stooge it off to you?
No.
Okay.
Let me just watch it on my own. Thank you.
All right. Fair enough. All right. Well, that brings us to our number one, Menders.
I'll bet
you can guess what it's going to be.
It better be Fink. There you go. Howard Finkel.
The all end all of all ring announcers. The great Howard Finkel. Plus,
I was just like, straight up, it better be Fink. Oh, Papa Pullman, where is Michael Buffer?
We couldn't afford him.
Yeah. That works.
Oh, my goodness. All right, so that concludes our Top 10 Tuesday for this week, this month, I guess, because we do it once a month. Next week, we will be doing the PWI flashback of Year Undetermined. I'll have that figured out by next Tuesday.
Yeah, that one's probably on the you.
Corny low-keeper. Who are you talking about, Bari?
Probably my.
Don't say Finkel.
I think it's Buffer.
Oh, no.
I
was more of a Bruce Buffer fan than Michael Buffer, to be honest with you.
I always loved Fink. I love Fink.
Fink was awesome.
Fink was awesome. Oh, Fink!
Really?
Really?
Oh, I...
My heart now hurts.
Don't blame the flavor saver for I need the phone information. Hey, if it wasn't for Howard Finkel, the biggest show of the year would be the Colossal Tussle.
That's true.
Because he came up with the name for WrestleMania.
All right.
All right. Well, Menders, we have tomorrow night on the 01 Shootout, we will be joined by Quest Parker.
And we'll be talking about tax return.
We will talk about the tax return show. We'll look ahead at, this coming Saturday, we're missing out on that one.
I kind of feel bad because they've made some more match announcements. Have you seen this?
I've seen some, yeah. They have some good matches on that show.
They do have some really good matches. It's just...
It's the commute. I don't want to pay to get into a motorcycle show. To go to a wrestling show.
Yeah.
Not saying you shouldn't, all of you, if you go, you want to see.
Yeah, all of you. If y'all want to go see some motocross and you want to see the guys come in on motorcycles, go for it. But
we'll see Rob Leach wedged into a go kart to do ring announcing.
It's not a go kart, it's a truck. It's like a tiny truck. But anyway, okay. My foot just doesn't handle outdoor walking on grass very well. So
I hear you. All right. Well, Menders, so that's what we got. Well, we were going to do a Gold Rush on Friday. We have to push it back another week because we got Marco's birthday on Friday. So we're not going to be home. Well, I mean, I think Bari's going too.
Oh, is he?
I think so. Bari, you going?
Bari, are you going to Marco's party?
Get some food at Pia's. Listen to some drunk people sing bad karaoke.
Oh, is it karaoke that night?
It's Marco's. He's going to go somewhere where there's karaoke.
I know.
No, and then maybe we can get SmackDown on one of the TVs.
I might talk to the Mitchell. Maybe we'll go.
Yeah, there you go. Bring Barkley.
No, we won't. She got Jacob. We can't go.
Bring Jacob.
We can't bring an 8-year-old to a bar.
Narge does. I'm kidding. He doesn't. Well, he does, but before hours.
They can be there before 9.
They'll be there before 9, but then they go home.
They can go to eat.
To get him in trouble here.
Yeah, all right. Trouble. That's on you, dude.
Yeah. Next week, Menders, we mentioned it. Kid Riot's going to be joining us.
I'm so excited.
Yeah. I just met him for the first time last month. And so we'll get his take on AVW because he's going to be on that show Sunday.
Now, hopefully, he'll be telling us about his victory.
Yes.
Because I picked Kid to win. So.
Yeah.
Although he's got some problems at MVW.
Oh.
He does.
Well, don't give away too much. We'll talk about all that next week.
Bao got his mask taken off.
Well, yeah. That's a no-no.
Carrot grabbed a hold of it.
Oh, Jimmy. Why?
Yep. Well, I mean, in all fairness, he was going against Jimmy in limbo.
Yeah. AJ says, still saying Melissa Santos is his top five ring announcer. She has a good voice that carries to the back of the building. She had passion in her voice for the people she was introducing, and for certain people she needed to get over, she would put a little... It sounds like Samantha Irvin.
She does. It
sounds like her, her modus operandi there.
It's very similar. It's very similar. But yeah, no, Kid had some problems because Napier was his tag partner. Napier turned on him. Napier joined the Cult of Basil. Kid almost lost his mask.
Wait, who joined the Cult of Basil?
Napier.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Napier was actually teaming with Kid when he turned. So poor Kid was out there like trapped with Napier, Limbo, and Carrot. So,
she said, "The Tantos walk so that Matt Irvin can run."
He's not lying. He's not lying. All right, let's get out of here. I'm hungry. All right. Reb.
Me too. All right. So until next week, for Menders, this is Reb. Remind you all, life is hard, work stiff, and we'll see you guys next time.
Thanks, guys.